Blues Playoff Hockey is brought to you by Bud Ice, the official beer sponsor of the NHL. Your Missouri, Illinois, Lincoln Mercury dealers. McDonald's, proud sponsors of the Blues. Have you had your break today? Southwest Airlines, fly Southwest, the low-fare airline. Pepsi, nothing else is a Pepsi. The Discover Card, it pays to discover. Your Midwest GMC truck dealers, Bellman, Bomarito, and Brockland GMC. Boatman's, with home equity loans designed to do just one sensible thing, save you money. Your neighborhood St. Louis Chrysler Plymouth dealers. CMS Home Mortgage Corporation. When the bank says no, CMS says yes. Hardee's, starring the best fried chicken in the game today. And by AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts. Saturday night in Vancouver, Curtis Joseph mobbed in triumph as the Blues rallied to tie the series at two games apiece. Tonight, the series returns to St. Louis in Kiel Center, where the Blues and Canucks split the first two games. It is Game 5 of the Western Conference quarterfinal best of seven series. And Kiel Center is ready for this big one between the Blues and the Canucks. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Game 5. Ken Wilson along with Joe Micheletti. Bruce Affleck is also here. They call Game 5 pivotal. Joe, and it's not a bad thing to call it because it's real clear. The team that loses tonight must win two in a row in order to advance in the playoffs. Everybody here hoping, Joe, that the Blues are the team that wins this game. And I guess the question is, what do the Blues have to do to get the victory?
Well, Kenny, we talked just prior to Game 3 about some of the things the Blues need to do, the keys to this series, and really the keys to the Blues. First of all, they've been a terrific forechecking team all season long. They did not do that very well in Games 2 or 3, and they lost. They did it very effectively in Game 4 and won the game. Number two, they have to continue to hit. When they hit, they can cause turnovers. They did in Game 4 and won the game. And number three, they have to play strong in their own zone. They did that in Game 4. They were very alert, and goaltending was always very important. Curtis Joseph, weak in Games 2 and 3, much better in Game 4.
Gained a lot of confidence. This entire Blues team, without question, gained confidence in game number four. And one of the big stars truly starred Saturday night in Vancouver, number 19, Brendan Shanahan.
Well, he decided to take over the game, scoring three goals. The first goal, Denny Chassé with a terrific play, and Shanahan moving in, getting the rebound, and the quick wrist shot of Shanahan. That tied the game at two, and that was Shanahan's first goal of the night. He followed that up by showing his strength, carrying the puck in from his side of the red line. Three Canuck players try to out-muscle him. He stays with it. There's traffic in front. The little wrist shot gets by McLean. That's his second goal, and that goal made it 3-2. And then the Blues went on the power play. Everyone thinks he's going to shoot. A hard pass all the way to the far corner to Al MacInnis. And then Shanahan going to the net. The perfect feed from Al MacInnis deflects it past Kirk McLean for the hat trick and a 4-2 Blues lead.
And that natural hat trick in the second period, the Blues playoff record for fastest three goals, 4 minutes and 16 seconds. And the big explosion when Jeff Norton ended up in the first row.
Yeah, there should have been an explosion after Shanahan's hat trick. This time Trevor Linden takes Norton into the glass and it just exploded on numerous people that were sitting behind the glass. Norton suffered some facial cuts, nothing too serious though, but a very dangerous situation.
Is there a home ice advantage in this series? It doesn't appear that way. And Bruce Affleck, if you go back to their regular season meetings between these two teams, they split in Vancouver and they split here at Kiel.
And I guess that's why you fight for the home ice advantage all season long. You know, you look at the Stanley Cup playoffs right now, Ken, and 18 out of 36 games are won by the road team. 500 hockey, that's unusual. The Blues fought for this. They have, it's a best two out of three now. They have two games at home, and that's what they've fought for. I've got to go along with Joe, though. The Blues have got to get on the Vancouver defense, make Kirk McLean back up into his name. They did that in Game 4. One of the best moves the Blues may have made, they pulled out Zombo and Dufresne, and Bill Holder and Lidstrom played extremely well. They pinched in very well. You notice that from all the Blues defense. I would expect a very physical game tonight in game number 5. Nothing different than that, obviously. Maybe it's the team that gets a good start, since it's an early start, will get the advantage in this game.
Check back with you during the course of this evening of hockey here at Kiel Center. The crowd is ready. It's the Canucks and the Blues in St. Louis, and it is game number 5. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey.
For tonight's game, back in goal for the Vancouver Canucks. He's had a terrific series up to this point. Will be Kirk McLean, and in goal for the Blues after coming off a weak game three. Curtis Joseph was terrific in game four. He's back in there again tonight. The starting goaltenders are brought to you by Southwest Airlines. Fly Southwest, the low fare airline. The officials for tonight's game, our referee will be Terry Gregson. The linesman, Brian Murphy and Mark Wheeler.
All right, folks, here we go. Pull up a chair. We've got Stanley Cup playoff hockey. Mike Keenan is ready. Said he wasn't relieved with the victory in game four. Said it was just a confidence builder. It's all part of the growing process in playoff competition. And he figures his team can go a long way. And they figure to go a long way if they can win tonight. Linden wins the draw, and the Canucks control in their own end. Lume clears the center ice. Here's Tiikkanen. He'll backhand the puck in. It's Creighton, Tiikkanen, and Hall, along with Barron and McKinnis. Now Linden carries the center ice. He's got Gino Odjic with him. Long shot, save, rebound. And Creighton clears to the neutral zone. Jure shoots the puck in. And McKinnis looks to carry it out and does with a nice move. Right wing to Hall over the blue line. A shot and a pad save by McLean, who clears to the corner. And the Canucks with the puck. Ojek feeds it far right wing. Jure against Barron. He stops, looks in front, and the pass off Barron's skate. Left point, Merzen shoots the puck around behind the net as he takes the Tiikkanen hit. Jure taken out by Barron. Odjic feeds to the blue line. Merzen, great shot. Joseph the save. And the puck deflects to the corner, now behind the net. And McKinnis takes over. He clears up the middle. Off Tiikkanen's stick, and Dana Merzen backhands the puck into the blue zone. And the two teams are changing. Now Barron, right wing to Chassé. Around a check, loses the puck. It's loose at center ice. Chassé shoots it in. Here's Dave Babbitt. Intercepted. LaPerriere to Chassé in the corner. He's pumped by Baranek. Now a chance for Shanahan. Behind the net to LaPerre. Trying to fend off Babbitt. And Rush Courtnall comes in to take the puck. Flies up the right wing over the red line. Long shot wide of the net. Puck in the blue zone. Played into the corner by Jeff Courtnall to brother Rush. And a pass back knocked away. Then Rush Courtnall steals. Feeds to the corner. Jeff Courtnall centers. Joseph knocks the puck away. Baranek taken out by LaPerriere. Russ Courtnall in the corner for Vancouver. To the right side. He shot goes off a leg and into the crowd. A deflection over the glass. Out of the corner, trying to move over to the right side. Russ Courtnall stops and lets one go, but blocked in good early action. A minute 55 gone. For Vancouver, not dressed, John Nemesnikov. Also, Adrian Aucoin, John McNamara, Jeff Brown, Martin Jelena, Mike Pekka, and Dane Jackson. For the Blues, Zombo, Karamanov, Twist, Tardif, Stastny, Dufresne, Batters, and Hollinger are scratched for Game 5.
And we should expect a physical game, and Jeff Norton with an early hit on Jeff Courtnall in the corner.
Blues control in their own end, and Lidstrom and Holder on defense. A pass too far for Anderson. Puck played out to center ice by everyone. There'll be no icing. Joseph has the puck behind the Blues net. He'll leave it for Doug Lidstrom. Lidstrom to Holder. Up the middle for Roberts. Off his skate too far. Roberts with Anderson and Gilbert. Now the puck shot into the Blues zone by Watton. And Joseph leaves it at the side of the net for Lidster. Up for Anderson. He'll deflect the puck by everyone down the ice. They wave off icing, and McLean leaves it for the 21-year-old defenseman Mark Watton. Left wing for Momesso. Lidster pinches in, blocks Momesso, takes a hit from Roberts, then Ronnie near his net. Cuts right in front of McLean, up to Momesso. He clears to the neutral zone, and the puck skips by Aksuda, and he knocks the Blues player down. Norton, Ronning can't get the puck. Holder knocks it ahead, and it's Gilbert getting it ahead to Roberts. He looks up, over skates, and here's Ronning into the Blues zone. Long shot, blocked by Joseph. He controls the rebound. Lister behind his net, loses the puck. Now looking to center, Ronning comes in front. He's checked, and Basil McRae takes over. His pass ahead, onto the stick of Todd Ellick, up to the red line. He'll shoot the puck in. Blues are changing. McLean clears it up the near wing. Stojevic can't clear it out. Long shot kicked out by McLean. Hunter taken out. Left point. Barron fans. Puck knocked to the corner. Tim Hunter leaves it behind his net for Dana Merzen. He's on with Jyrki Luoma. Merzen clears the puck to center ice. It'll slide deep into the Blues end. Joseph leaves it behind the net for McInnes. His pass knocked away. Bouncing puck, and McInnes slaps it out. Puck slides into the Vancouver zone, and here's Dana Merzen. And both teams are changing. Over to Luoma. Pass ahead for Linden, tipped by him. And it's McInnes back at his own end. Up to Jeff Norton at the red line. His pass knocked away by Luoma, and now a penalty will be called. Barry Gregson calls the first penalty of the game. 4 minutes in, no score. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
The Blues will get the first power play of the night. Behind the play, Dana Merzen got tangled up with Basil McRae as they separated. Merzen tried to go to the bench. On his way to the bench, he tripped McRae, and the Blues are on the power play.
2 minutes for tripping at 4 minutes. Blues go to work. Duchesne in his own end to Roberts. Roberts now to McInnes. He's poke checked, and it's an offside call against Vancouver. The Blues power play in this series. 4 goals in 25 attempts. And on the other side, obviously, Vancouver in the 25 shorthanded situations allowing the 4 goals. But importantly, Vancouver has struck for the 3 shorthanded goals.
Well, the difference between Vancouver's penalty teams and most other teams is that they try to score shorthanded. They're very aggressive after the puck.
Linden is doing some more checking here. And Duchesne skating with a puck. And the referee, Terry Gregson, blows the whistle. And he is going to nail Al McInnes for interference. And McInnes goes to the penalty box. That's the kind of thing that people at times have complained about trying to get rid of in the National Hockey League. We don't see calls like that, however, very often.
Well, Duchesne had the puck. McInnes comes all the way over. And Linden was close to being able to forecheck Duchesne, and McInnes comes over, interferes with him, and right from the opening faceoff, referee Terry Gregson calling things very close.
4-on-4, and the faceoff near Joseph. Hall and Shanahan, Duchesne and Norton against Linden and Bure, Hedekin and Babich. Trevor Linden, he's huge, 6'4", 210, the 25-year-old captain of the Canucks. Ready to drop the puck, they do. Duchesne slides it behind the net, and here's Norton.
Near side for Shanahan. Up to center ice. Into the middle to Duchesne, who played well in game four. Drop pass. Hull. Wrist shot. Save. And Shanahan covered well by Linden, looking for the rebound. Babich to Linden. Not a Hedekin. He reaches the red line with a feed to Bure, moving in on the right wing. Bad angle shot blocked by Norton, who takes out Bure. Then in the near corner, Norton loses the puck. Linden looks to center, leaves the puck for Bure along the near boards. Both teams shorthanded. Bure in the slot around Duchesne in front of Loney. Shoots, he scores! Oh, what a play! Pavel Bure! He moves around Steve Duchesne to get in alone. And in a four-on-four situation, Pavel Bure gets his fourth goal of the playoffs.
Well, Jeff Norton, the other Blues defenseman, was tangled up with Trevor Linden. And Bure, because of all the room, he gets Duchesne coming one way, and he is so quick. And then finally just puts it over the shoulder of Curtis Joseph. But Duchesne was coming out away from the net. Bure coming at him, and just a little stutter step. And quickly he's passed Duchesne. Joseph goes down, and Bure, who's been terrific this series, puts it high over Joseph's left shoulder, and it's 1-0 Vancouver.
4:55, the time of the goal. Hedekin and Linden assisting. Bure's fourth of the playoffs. And in game five, the Canucks get the lead. It's 4-on-4 from center ice. Lume into the Blues zone. Backhands the puck in front out of Rush Cortnall's reach. And the Blues pick it up. Carboneau out of his own end. Hits it ahead and Holder dumps it in. Paul and Carboneau after it behind the net. Carboneau taken down. McLean into the corner to Ronnie. He's bumped by Barron. They can't clear. Left point Holder. Wrist shot, and it goes off Ronnie to the near side. And weaving back in his own zone with a puck, Russ Cortnall. He'll leave it near corner for Lume. Lume and Cullimore. Russ Cortnall and Ronnie for Vancouver. Up to Jason Cullimore. From center ice, dumping the puck in. Barron beats Ronnie to it. Now to Dave Roberts. In 20 seconds, the Canucks get a man back, and the puck goes out of play, and the action stopped. Shy of the six-minute mark here in the first period, and the Blues are trailing 1-0.
Boy, Pavel Bure has been something in this series. He has scored at least 1 point now in five games in this series. The Blues are trying to keep free ice and open ice away from Pavel Bure. Boy, he had just a little bit of room there, and Linden doing the job interfering on Norton. That gave Bure more room, and he left Duchesne standing there. Duchesne tried to chop him over the back, and Bure went right through that, fights him off, and boy, he's a player. He can do everything.
Face off in the Blues end. Babich gets the puck, tries to control, does near the blue line. Ahead too far for Jeff Cortnall. He knocks down Norton from behind. There'll be a penalty, and the Blues get a free moment. Joseph to the bench. Hull comes on. Tiikkanen into the offensive zone to Hull. Behind the net to Tiikkanen on a delayed penalty. And then the Canucks touch the puck as Hedekin is able to reach in, and the penalty is called against Vancouver. Now, the original Vancouver penalty to Merzen had just ended.
Jeff Cortnall forechecking on Jeff Norton. There's a cross check from behind. Norton goes down. The puck goes three. And the referee, Terry Gregson, was in the corner. No question on the call. And the Blues will play 4-on-4 now for the next 17 seconds. And then the Blues will go on the power play.
The 17 seconds remaining in the penalty to Al McInnes. Mike Keenan wanting to match players, match lines a lot in this game. I asked him before the game, I said, are you going to go with Shanahan, with LaPerriere and Chassé again like you did a lot in game four? He says, I only know when I see what the Canucks do, how many matchups they're going to try to get, how long their shifts are going to be. He says, after a shift or two, then I'll know how I'm going to go with my team.
And Rick Lee, on the other hand, the coach of the Canucks, doesn't like to try and match lines. He likes to keep his team out there for full shifts.
Now at center ice, the Blues get the puck. Shanahan to Roberts. 4-on-4. He'll fire it in. Babich gets it, clears the puck out. At center ice, Hull. Ahead too far for Shanahan. Blues have one defenseman on Norton, and here come the Canucks. Now McInnes on the ice. Power play Blues. A pass for Linden too far. And Norton just shoots the puck into the Vancouver end. Babich ahead. And Ruutu dumps it to the Blues defense. Now the Blues go to work. McInnes to Roberts on the right wing into the Vancouver zone. He pulls up along the near boards. Power play for a minute 22. Straight away, McGinnis shot right on, save, rebound, Shanahan has the rebound, shot knocked away, and the puck cleared up the boards. Here's Bure pulling away from Roberts. Right wing for Russ Courtnall. Vancouver shorthanded. Courtnall into the corner. Has the puck taken away by McGinnis, who feeds ahead to Shanahan. Now Shanahan up to center ice. Near wing from McGinnis, and he'll slap the puck in around behind the Canucks net. Far corner, Jyrki Lumme wheels and fires the puck the length of the ice. The Blues are trailing 1-0 in the first period. Less than 50 seconds to go now in their power play. Bure scoring the Vancouver goal at 4:55. On the far wing, Ellick into the Vancouver end, into the corner, fires around behind the net, near side, Shanahan trying to center, and the puck knocked away by Ruutu, kept in by McGinnis, but only for a moment, and at center ice, Shanahan. Back to his own line, over to Duchesne, he rushes to the red line, carries over the Vancouver line, drops the puck, Hall, right wing to Shanahan, and a pass back for McGinnis, tipped away, and then a feed to Hall, and he'll carry to center ice. The crowd is a little impatient. Hall into the Vancouver end, puck swept away, goes wide of the net, Hall taken out, loose puck in the corner for Ellick. 5 seconds to go on the power play, Duchesne, right point, Lidster, a shot, and that's blocked at the defense by Dana Merzen, and he'll clear the puck out. And Russ Courtnall and Jeff Courtnall both have had a big impact in this series and have early. Jeff Courtnall back on, big check by Momesso on Lidster, and the puck dumped behind the Blues net. 8:15 gone, first period. Blues are down 1-0. Over to LaPerriere from Duchesne, fighting his way to center ice to Creighton. Now right wing, Lidster moving in, good chance, he took it, score! No, offside, offside! The play offside. The Blues offside at the Vancouver blue line. There is no goal.
And Denny Chassé doesn't like this call. He says he was standing on the line and he is still arguing the call. The long pass, Chassé stopped. Boy, hard to tell if he had his foot on the line or not from that angle. He thought he did. And in either case, the goal is disallowed.
1-0 Vancouver. This is St. Louis Blues hockey. Now the play resumes at center ice, and the Blues have the puck. Chassé tries to shoot it in. It's taken by Watton, played ahead, and shot into the Blues zone by Momesso. Here's Holder back. Loses the puck. Ruutu with it. He's checked by LaPerriere, trying to work in front. Big Romanov Suda. Holder knocks him down, and the puck taken by LaPerriere. Here's a 3-on-2 with Shanahan and Chassé. LaPerriere works in front, shoots, and the puck flutters wide. Lumme behind his net. Up for Momesso. The puck goes by him. It'll slide down the ice. They'll wave off icing. Canucks are changing. Up to Chassé. A pass ahead. Watton controls in front of the penalty benches. Flips the puck towards the Blues net. McGinnis back to play it. Off the boards, taking the puck, Linden working to the corner. Ridden along the way behind the net by Holder, and he's unable to center. Bure overskates in the corner, now centered by Linden. Quick shot by Ojek, and it kind of flutters off Joseph. He'd grab it and hold on as Linden and Ojek kind of bumped teammates right after the whistle. So 9.5 minutes gone in the first period. Pavel Bure has the only goal.
Denny Chassé argued the call. It's very difficult to tell from our replay whether it was offside or not. You see Chassé stopping. He had one leg up. Then I believe he lifts the skate up again. Now he might have been able to get back, but hard to tell with Lidster coming in the other side whether he had already crossed the line or not. The whistle had blown because you could see McLean. McLean just stopped on the play.
Canucks win the draw on the Blues end, but can't keep the puck in. Babbitt shoots it in. Played by Ellick, near side to McGinnis, up to Anderson. His pass at the red line for Gilbert, knocked away, but here's Ellick on the far wing. He's hit by Babbitt. Loose puck slides behind the net. Gilbert gives it to Ellick in front, and the pass for Anderson. He's tied up, far point, fair, and a blast, and it deflects behind the net off Ferranic. Centered again by Ellick off his skate, and here's Russ Courtnall breaking out. With brother Jeff, he'll fire the puck in, wide of the net. Jeff Courtnall after it, tied up, knocked down by Anderson. McGinnis behind the net, up the far wing to Gilbert. He chops the puck ahead, Anderson kicks it to center ice. carries through the neutral zone, slaps the puck in. McLean slows it down behind the net. Here's Hedekin tearing up the boards. Duchesne unable to keep it in at the point. Played ahead by Jeff Cortinall and deep into the St. Louis end. Both teams are changing. 10:30 gone, first period. Blues trail 1-0 in game 5. Hall gets the puck from Tiikkanen into the Vancouver zone. Now to Duchesne moving up from the defense, but there'll be a penalty call. And it'll be against Vancouver for interference, and Terry Gregson is not letting a thing go. Here in the first period, Jyrki Lume, the veteran Canucks defenseman, goes off in an angry manner.
And because of all the penalties in this first period, there hasn't been a real flow established on an even strength basis by either team. Meanwhile, Hull had the puck, but in center ice, Tiikkanen and Lume are together. Tiikkanen's trying to get away. Lume just goes after him, gets a stick on him, and ended up pulling him down. And Lume goes off for interference. 9:19 to go in this first period. The Blues will go on the power play, trailing 1-0.
I think Terry Gregson recently read a memo about interfering and said, hey, you interfere, you're going to the penalty box. 10:41, and the Canucks will be shorthanded. Rick Lee not happy at all. The Blues on the power play are 0-2. Bure scored his fourth playoff goal at 4:55 when both teams were shorthanded. Face off in the Vancouver end. McGinnis at the right point. He gets the pass right from the draw. Slides the puck ahead. It's intercepted. And Ruutu clears it the length of the ice. Duchesne will go back. Duchesne and McGinnis, Ellick, Hall, and Shanahan.
Again, the other power plays the Blues had, they had some opportunities to shoot the puck. They elected to pass. They've got to get some shots.
Now the Blues are offside at the Vancouver line. And we'll have a face-off out in the neutral center ice area. Brett Hall has been battered about late in the regular season and in the playoffs, but this time of the year you go every game.
And you know that he is going to get going one of these days. Of course, he scored earlier, but hasn't scored much in the series. And once he gets going, he can get on a roll unlike just about any other player in the league.
Two goals, one assist for Hall in the first four games. Blues shoot the puck in, far wing, Shanahan. Left point, Duchesne. Straight away, McGinnis, bouncing puck. Ahead to Ellick. He swipes at it, can't connect. Here's Hall in the corner, along the near side to Todd Ellick. Shanahan's in front. Ellick out near the blue line. The puck stolen by Hedekin. Two on one with Bure. McGinnis back. Hedekin breaks in alone. He shoots, hits the post. Puck in the crease. And McGinnis gets it ahead to Hall. He's got a breakaway. Hall in on McLean. He shoots. And McLean, a great save on Hall. Now the puck centered. And knocked down on the play is Ellick. And the Canucks clear to center ice. Boy, after the puck hit the post behind Joseph, McGinnis trying to clear it. Looked like he hit Joseph in the leg and had to clear in a second effort. Blues work in again. Shanahan, a pass deflects over the net. Here's Hull, far side to the blue line. LePerrier shoots and the puck deflects high and wide. Hull to Shanahan behind the net. Berzin on Shanahan. Shanahan off the far board, bouncing puck to the point. Kept in by Norton. Now to Shanahan on the left wing side of the net. Hull, he shoots, he scores! Oh, baby, what a move! Brett Hull, a power play goal! Crazy, and Hall with a whirling move at the post ties it at one.
Brendan Shanahan makes the play. Now number 5 is Berzin. He tries to draw a penalty on Shanahan by letting go of his stick, and that turns out to be a key play because Shanahan ends up with the puck on the boards. Berzin with no stick, and Shanahan is able to feed the perfect pass to Hall on the side of the net, who puts it in. Merzen's stick was in the corner, and Hall, with a terrific move from the side of the net, just whirls and puts in the power play goal to tie it up.
That is the 5th playoff power play goal for the Blues. They've really done fairly well on the power play in this series. Third goal for Hull, 12-10 the time, and it ties it at 1.
Well, I think if Merzin had another choice, he would have held on to his stick, because there's no question he wanted to draw the penalty, and he started. He was hacking Shanahan from behind the net, and the stick ended up underneath Shanahan's arm. He just squeezed together, and Merzin let go of the stick.
From the faceoff at center ice, Lidster ahead for Anderson, too far. Merzin back behind his net. Golfs the puck up the boards and down the ice. It'll go over the end red line. They'll wave off icing. Here's Holder. Holder and Lidster. Ellis. Anderson and Gilbert up front. Long pass by Lidster, by everyone the length of the ice, but right to netminder, Kirk McLean. He clears to Lumen. Hunter on a line with Ronning. And Stoyanov up the near board. Stoyanov hit by Lidster. Lidster sends the puck towards the net, played by Lume off the shoulder of Ronnie. Loose in the blue zone, and coming back is Lidster. He's covered. Anderson can't get the puck. Then a whirling shot by Hunter deflects to Joseph and cleared away. Glenn Anderson with the puck behind his net. Run by Hunter. Up the near boards for Carboneau. His pass intercepted. Stoyanov feeds behind the net. And Stoyanov dumped by Lidster, and Anderson from behind his goal sends the puck high in the air out to center ice. 6:43 to go in the first period. It's 1-1. Hall at 12-10 from Shanahan and Norton, a power play. Carboneau taken down in the Vancouver end. Now McInnes is shot wide. Far side, Barron. He'll knock the puck into the corner. It goes behind the net, and Cliff Ronning, number 7 for Vancouver. He'll clear the puck ahead. It's out of the reach of Ojek. He and Barron after the puck. Ojek takes the man, Barron. McInnes back up the near side. Hall clears to center ice. Behind the play, McInnes wrestles down Momesso. Puck in the Vancouver end. Hedekin ahead to Oksuda. Circling in his own zone. Roman Oksuda fans on a pass, but Dave Babich covers up. The crowd chanting, "Let's go Blues! Let's go Blues!" Up to Ruutu. He tips the puck into the St. Louis end. No icing. Here's McInnes. Up the far wing for Tekin and on with Carboneau and Hall. Then the puck stolen by Ruutu but handed to McInnes. With Hall over the Vancouver line. Blues are changing. McInnes a shot and it's knocked away by Dave Babich. LaPerriere after ball. LaPerriere takes a look like a glove, maybe a straight arm in the mouth from Hedekin, and there'll be a penalty called against Brett Hedekin. Bure and Hall, the headliners in the series, have scored, and this is St. Louis Blues hockey.
David Babich with the puck, Brett Hedekin interfering for him on LaPerriere after the play. LaPerriere with the quick right hand to the chin, and LaPerriere goes down, Hedekin goes off, and the Blues go on the power play.
LaPerriere has the ability to leave his skates in a hurry and go down like he might be near death.
I thought he was out.
Hedekin roughing at 14:20. Duchesne from center ice fires the puck in. Blues on the power play looking to take the lead. Canucks get the puck, clear it ahead. It bounces to center ice. Here's Russ Courtnall, always dangerous with his team shorthanded. Look at the magic. Now far side for Lume, breaking in on the right wing. And McInnes gets in his way and takes the puck. McInnes and Duchesne now ahead to Hall with Shanahan and Ellick. A Hall pass turned away. Bury gives the puck right back. Now Duchesne over the blue line. Right wing to Shanahan, working in front. Oh, the puck just out of the reach of Ellick. Hall sends the puck behind the net to Shanahan. He works to the far corner. Goes to the left point to Duchesne. Right point to McInnes. Lines up. And a shot pass hits Ellick in the skate, and the puck ends up the length of the ice. Both teams are changing. Joseph ahead to McInnes at the red line. He fires the puck in. Babich plays it off the boards. Feeds it off the far boards the length of the ice. Now 54 seconds to go in this Blues power play. It's 1-1. 4.5 minutes remaining in the first period. Up the left wing, Roberts. One man back, Watton. A shot, save, rebound! McLean reaches out to knock the puck away with his stick, and now play stopped by Terry Gregson. Wow. Was that a close call? The Blues coming oh so close on what almost really turned out to be a broken play to scoring, and the puck almost went in on the second effort.
What a pass from the veteran Tekinen at center ice. Just deflects it right over to Roberts, who is streaking down the left side. And then Roberts uses some patience, holds on. One shot is blocked, had his rebound, but two Vancouver players there. And Roberts couldn't finish it off. The first one, whoa, what a save by McLean. Oh,
wasn't that a great save?
The second replay shows McLean, who was down, just diving with his stick and making the save on Roberts.
Made the great save on a rebound. Tiikkanen sets up on the right wing boards below us. In the corner to Roberts, back to Tiikkanen. He'll shoot, deflection, McLean the save, puck loose behind the net. Roberts dumped by Watton, it comes in front. Holder, right wing to Tiikkanen. He waits for traffic, shoots, hits the side of the net. Now a race for the puck in the corner. Watton gets there, up to Ruutu, and he'll flip the puck out. It'll come down at the St. Louis line. Holder back to play it. 13 seconds remaining in the Blues power play. 1-1, the Blues and Canucks here in game five. The series tied, two victories apiece. Up the Creighton, into the Vancouver end, into the corner, into the boards by Watson. Lume behind the net, checked by Roberts. Then Creighton gets the puck. Now Hedekin back on, the penalty over. Creighton trying to center, and the puck batted down. Hedekin feeds it ahead to Jeff Courtnall, too far, and Holder slaps it right back in for the Blues. Both clubs are changing. Now the Canucks out of their own end. Here's Jeff Courtnall on a feed from Hedekin to the red line. He gets slammed by LaPerriere, and there'll be a penalty, and now the Canucks try to get to LaPerriere. Jeff Courtnall seemed to have his head slammed into the boards. He is dazed. 3:19 to go in the opening period. The Canucks and Blues are tied at one, and this is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Ian LaPerriere will get the penalty on Jeff Courtnall. Just before the hit, Courtnall tries to turn out of the way, so he ends up facing the glass, and his head hit the glass straight on. What a tremendous hit by LaPerriere. And Courtnall, eyes glazed, doesn't know where he is right now. He had a lot of trouble getting off the ice. LaPerriere came all the way over from the center ice. Courtnall made one move. You can see, just as LaPerriere went to hit him, Courtnall turned to face the glass. LaPerriere didn't go for the fake at all, and Courtnall head first into the boards.
LaPerriere is receiving a 5-minute major. Could have been charging, could have been boarding. He gets an elbowing penalty at 16:41. Mike Keenan does not agree. And the Blues, and it's happened before in this series, will be shorthanded for 5 minutes. It's 1-1. Blues control the puck in their own end. McInnes drives it off the boards. Played in the Vancouver end by Lume. Blues killing the penalty with Carboneau and Hull. McInnes and Barron. Here's Ronning carrying into the St. Louis zone. Far wing to Linden. Linden along the far board. Setting up at the blue line is Jure. He's at the right point. Lume at the near point below us. Linden continuing to stick handle, leaves the puck for Ronning. Now in front, Lume deflects the puck wide. Lume in the corner. A 5-minute Vancouver power play. Now out from Linden to the blue line to Bure, near point to Lume, over to Bure, back to Lume. Now the puck knocked to center ice by Hall. Lume controls to Bure. This could be the turning point of this entire game, the pivotal fifth game of the series. Carboneau gets the puck, shoots it down the ice. McLean out and clears it onto the bench of the Canucks as Shanahan was racing in. There is 2:25 to go in the first period. 4:05 left in LaPerriere's penalty. And the Blues and Canucks are tied at one. Fans Bud Ice, the only beer cool enough to be the official beer sponsor of the NHL.
Kenny, I felt coming into this game tonight that this would be the best game that we have seen thus far, because both teams, I think, when you look at this series tied 2-2, one team would play well, the other one not very well, and it was back and forth a little bit. This being such an important game for both teams, I thought it would be the best game, and thus far, it really has. We're seeing both teams come out. Rick Lee wasn't happy with the physical play of his team in game four. They've come out and played much more physical, especially their bigger players. And the Blues have continued to play that way.
Russ Courtnall in his own end. Power play Vancouver. Russ Courtnall shy of the red line. Shoots the puck in off the stick of Momesso. Joseph out of the net. Clears around far side. And Russ Courtnall there at the blue line. Plays it ahead. Joseph Beranek. Side of the net to Momesso. He's got Jure in front. Back to Beranek. In the far corner to Momesso. Russ Courtnall and Jure out there. Here's Russ Courtnall. Right wing Beranek. He'll shoot over the net. Might have been deflected, and the puck caroms to center ice. 1:50 to go here in the period. Well, one of the good points on this 5-minute shorthanded situation for the Blues. The intermission is going to break it up. That helps a little. Beranek carries in into the slot. The puck knocked away by Carboneau, but kept in by Babbitt. Then Duchesne over skates out of the corner. Momesso. Duchesne steals. Can't clear, but Carboneau gets the puck. Feeds it ahead to Hull. The pass behind him and the puck the length of the ice. 1:25 to go in the first period. Jure scoring at 4:55 for Vancouver. In a 4-on-4 situation, then a power play goal from Brett Hull at 12:10. Canucks at center ice. Linden backhands the puck in. It slides to Joseph. He makes the save. Barron clears up far side. Tikkanen tips the puck by Bure the length of the ice. Now a 1:02 to go in period one. The shot, 7 aside. Now Ronning loses the puck in his own end. Shanahan trying to get around Lube, unable to. Ronning up to the red line. Under a 1:00 to go in the first period. Ronning over the St. Louis line. Shoots the puck behind the net. Left there for Barron. Clears it off Lube, but he keeps it in. Ahead for Jeff Courtnall out of his reach. Here's McInnes in the corner. 40 seconds to go in the period. He'll clear it. Not out. Right point, Ronning. Far side, Jeff Courtnall looking in front to Hedekin. And he deflects the puck just wide. Checked by Barron. Ronning behind the net, unable to center. Far side, Jeff Courtnall to the blue line to Lume. Back to Jeff Courtnall. He fakes a shot in the corner to Ronning. Far side to Jeff Courtnall. He'll shoot, and the shot deflects wide. Ronning behind the Blues net. Comes in front, shoots. Joseph the save, rebound, and it's tipped away. Here's Hennigan at the near point. 8 seconds to go. He winds up, he shoots, and the puck goes wide. Then deflects off the boards and over the glass into the crowd. And play stop with 3.5 seconds remaining in a hectic first period here at Kiel Center, and the Blues are shorthanded. It's 1-1. Well, Saturday night, the St. Louis Stampede, undefeated here at Kiel, hosts the Connecticut Coyotes. Arena football, fun, fast, and in your face. Tickets available, all Tickets Now outlets, the Kiel Center box office, and all 6 Blue Note sports shops, or you can order by phone by calling 291-7600. Arena football here at Kiel on Saturday night.
And Mike Keenan really giving referee Terry Gregson an earful. He was right down on the bench. Gregson still, they're still arguing over there. Keenan still going at it with Gregson, who had come all the way over to the Blues bench for the discussion.
Now they have a neutral faceoff. Cullimore with a puck, and that is the end of the first period. Now don't forget that penalty, the 5-minute major to Ian LaPerriere will carry well over into the second period. Pavel Bure and Brett Hull have scored. Shots favoring Vancouver 9-7 in the first period. The Canucks and Blues in game 5 after a period tied at 1. Coming up in this first intermission, Bruce Affleck will have as his guest Blues defenseman Jeff Norton. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey. Welcome back to Kiel Center. After 1 period in game 5, the Vancouver Canucks and St. Louis Blues are tied at 1. Jeff Norton coming over during the season from San Jose. 35 playoff games in his NHL career. He's been a standout in this series, and Jeff is with Bruce Affleck.
Well, thank you, Cam. Get a chance to visit with Jeff Norton. And first of all, we'll go back into the regular season a little bit. Player of the month for April, a good finish for you. I guess things feel pretty good in a Blues uniform.
Yeah, it's been a good transition, and I was happy to come here. I had a good time in San Jose, but, you know, coming here to a team that, you know, can legitimately take a run at the Stanley Cup is all a player can ask for.
That first period seemed pretty intense. Your thoughts on the first?
It was. You know, I think both teams are trying to go out and take control. You know, it's series is tied 2-2, and it's a real crucial game. You know, either up 3-2 or down 2-2. So we knew it was going to be this kind of a game. There's been some heavy hitting and, you know, end-to-end action, and, you know, I guess it's pretty entertaining.
Is there a prize for the best goatee in this team for the playoffs?
I think so. I think I'm making a pretty good run at it.
As you go into this second period, you're still a man short, 5-minute major to LaPerriere. Anything you have to do, I mean, you just get through it, and that's the first thing you think about?
I think so. You know, we kill it off, and I think then the momentum will take us. If we can kill it off and really, you know, come out of it pumped up and ready to go, and I think that will take a little bit out of them as well. And it always seems if you kill off a big penalty, you know, something, a penalty that you really didn't agree on, it just gets you going. So, you know, hopefully you can kill the remainder of it off and get going from there.
all your good plays should probably be the highlights, but you know, the one that's going to stick out, of course, is the one in Vancouver the other night. We're going to take a look at it. Tell us, I guess, your immediate thoughts when you saw the glass explode.
Well, I just it kind of scared me a little bit because all I heard was a big, you know, boom. And, you know, fortunately, I came out of it okay. The glass, you know, scattered everywhere. And unfortunately for the people who were in the crowd, got a little bit cut up. But, you know, fortunately for me, I escaped without too much injury.
Good gesture by Trevor Linden to try and help you there.
It was. You know, I think anybody would do it. Nobody wants to see anyone get seriously hurt out there. I mean, it's a classic Trevor Linden finishing the play with a big hit. And, you know, that's just how he plays. And, you know, obviously, the look on his face, I thought I was more seriously injured, but, I thank him for trying to get me out of there.
And what some people may not realize is you took a hit to make a play, right?
Yeah, you got to. It was playoff hockey, and that's what it's all about.
Jeff, good luck in the second period, and good luck. Let's get two more wins under our belt here.
Yeah, I hope so. Thanks, Bruce.
That's Blues defenseman Jeff Norton. Now let's go back upstairs to Ken Wilson.
For being our guest tonight, Jeff Norton receives a gift certificate to Spiro's Family Restaurants. If you enjoy great food from fresh seafood flown in daily to delicious, thick, juicy steaks cut from black Angus beef, then be sure to try one of the four convenient Spiro's locations. Natural Bridge at Hanley, Watson at Arsenal, Woods Mill and Olive, and the Tenderloin Room in the Park Plaza. Getting ready for the second period at Kiel, the Canucks and Blues are tied at one. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey. Coming up next here on St. Louis 11, a look at the Blues' resident artist, Rick Zombo.
Best of five between the Blues and the Canucks. The series all tied up at two apiece, and we're tied after one period of play as Bure and Hull have got the goals for their respective teams. St. Louis Blues Hockey is brought to you in part by BMW, the ultimate driving machine. To arrange a test drive, phone your nearest BMW dealer. By Southwestern Bell Mobile Systems, because a cellular phone is not a luxury, it's a necessity. By your 29 St. Louis area Dobbs dealers. And by Domino's Pizza, and it's gotta be good, and it's gotta be now, it's gotta be Domino's. Tonight's Southwest Airlines Blue Note, it's a fact, in 1989, on their way to the Stanley Cup Championship, Calgary defenseman Al MacInnis led all playoff scorers with 31 points. Al was awarded the Conn Smythe Trophy as the most valuable player in the playoffs. Southwest Airlines, it's just plain smart to fly Southwest, the low-fare airline. Welcome back to Kiel Center, and a good job by the Blues coming back. They'll have to kill off a little bit of a power play in that start of the second. We're going to take a look at off-ice feature of Rick Zombo, who is the resident artist. It used to be Todd Ewan, but now it's Rick Zombo.
With its passing, skating, and overall speed and grace, the game of hockey is often thought of as an art form. Ballet on ice, only with sticks, pucks, and checks. One Blues player has taken that notion a step further.
It opened new doors to meet people. You know, here's a jock with another interest.
Blues defenseman Rick Zombo goes a long way towards dispelling the old jock stereotype. For years, he's filled these pages with sketches of powerful influences in his life. For instance, his love of horses and rodeos, motorcycles, and of course, hockey. And a few celebrities thrown in for good measure. This is actor Don Johnson. Then there's the Duke. Do you recognize these other stars?
Say that woman, way on down, and a little of that human touch.
Well, I think I was drawing when I was a little kid, and I enjoyed drawing. It gave me time by myself, and the more I grew, the better I got. Throughout the course of the season, you have a lot of ups and downs, and you try to, you know, level that off and not bring it to your family life. Nothing worse than coming home and kicking the dog, you know, per se, just because you had a bad game. This is therapeutic to me. It relaxes me.
Like his teammates, Zombo lives and breathes hockey, especially on the road. That's also a good time to sharpen up on his artistic skills.
To be constructive, you know, most people will play cards or go to movies or hang out like that, and I do my artwork. I'll ask them, does that look like John Wayne's nose? You know, and I think I'm a bad critic, but man, you never expect to get a straight answer out of them.
Recently, Zombo combined his love of art and hockey, coming out with a children's coloring book called Discovering Hockey. He actually didn't draw these pictures, but supervised the project throughout.
And is it, there is a resemblance here?
There might be a resemblance. The four is the obvious one. Maybe the chin is another one.
Up next from Zombo Enterprises, a coloring book about fishing. But first, there's the playoffs to deal with. And who knows, if the Blues win it all, maybe this artist's next sketch won't be of Bruce or Ray or Don, but a cup which has special meaning for Blues fans everywhere.
Good job by our producer, Jim Duff from Bud Sports. Our thanks to him, and a good job by Rick Zombo, and what a talent he has off the ice. Well, it's 1-1 after one period of play. When we come back, we'll take a look at highlights from the first period. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey.
Just about ready for the start of the second period here at Kiel, and the Blues and Canucks are tied at one. Ken Wilson and Joe Micheletti welcoming you back. Obviously a very good first period, and we have to remember that that five-minute penalty to Ian LaPerriere carries over into the second, but boy, that magic that Pavel Bure has, he made quite a play.
Boy, when he has some open ice, he can do some wonderful things. Now he gets helped up by Trevor Linden interfering with Jeff Norton. That allowed Bure to make a few moves. He catches Steve Duchesne going one way, beats him, and then walks in on Joseph and puts it high over his shoulder to give Vancouver a 1-0 lead.
Then Brett Hull, a power play goal.
Well, what a play by Brendan Shanahan. He fights away from Dana Merzen. Merzen stays with him, and then Merzen ends up losing his stick. Shanahan will get the puck. Now watch, he's got time. Merzen, it's tough to defend against Shanahan without a stick. He slipped the puck right through the legs to Brett Hull, and Hull with a powerful move coming from the side of the net. Perfect pass from Shanahan. Now watch Hull. He just goes right to the front of the net, reaches around, and puts it in the far side to tie the game at one.
Bure's fourth playoff goal at 4:55 from Linden and Hedekin came with the teams both shorthanded. Hull's power play goal from Shanahan and Norton, his third at 12:10. Shots, Vancouver 9, St. Louis 7. The period summary brought to you by your Midwest GMC truck dealers, Bellman, Bomarito, and Brocklin GMC. The teams are back for the second period at Kiel Center. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey. Going into the second period, the Canucks and Blues are tied at one. And always remember, folks, it is not hockey without the ice, Bud Ice.
Now starting this period, the Blues will be shorthanded for another minute and 35 seconds.
And we're underway, and the Canucks, Jerky Lume, takes the puck all the way back behind his net. He is on with Ronnie, Linden, Bure, and Jeff Portnoy. Four forward, Bure playing the point. Blues intercept, and the puck shot the length of the ice. McInnes, Barron, Carboneau, and Hull killing the penalty for St. Louis. Half a minute into the second period, 1-1. Here is the speed of Bure into the blue zone. Right wing. Ronnie knocks the puck behind the net. McInnes gets there. Fans trying to clear. Now Hull can't get the puck around Lume, who keeps it in. Puts it behind the net. And McInnes takes over, drives it off the boards. And out at center ice, Pavel Bure knocks the puck down. 51 seconds to go in the power play for Vancouver. A five-minute power play. Lume over the line, shooting the puck towards the net. Looked like it was headed wide as Joseph catches the puck and holds on to stop play with 45 seconds remaining in the Ian LaPerriere penalty.
Jurgen Lume has been one of the key players for this Vancouver Canucks team, especially in the absence of Jeff Brown. There's still some question as to whether Jeff Brown will return for this series or not, but Lume, especially on the power play with Brown out of there, is going to get a tremendous amount of ice time.
The faceoff will come to Curtis Joseph's right. Shanahan against Baranek, who wins the draw. Back to the left point. The puck skips away from Lume. He gives it to Bure. Now Lume up to the checkered red line. Blasts it in around behind the net out the near side. Just Portnoy can't stop it. And Bure at the red line with the puck again. He moves around Tekin and feeds left wing to Lume into the St. Louis end. Knocked down by Duchesne. The puck into the corner. Baranek beaten to it by Shanahan. He'll backhand the puck ahead to Tekin and he'll drive it the length of the ice. Right over the net and off the glass. LaPerriere back in 13 seconds. It's the Blues one and the Canucks one. Lume left wing. Bure through center ice. Into the St. Louis end.
stop. Speed straight away. Lume, a shot right on. Head save. Joseph and Duchesne clears the puck out, and LaPerriere back. The crowd really appreciates the Blues penalty killing. Now Baranek, right wing, Russ Courtin all over the St. Louis line, curls, feeds into the middle, and LaPerriere chops the puck away. At center ice, Hedekin, a pass, hits a leg. Now it's Creighton ahead, near wing for Chassé over the line. Hedekin gets in his way. Puck in the corner. Babich there. He gets hit by LaPerriere. Chassé behind the net. He can't center. Then a pass behind the goal, out of the reach of Creighton. Puck cleared by Hedekin out to center ice. This is Doug Lidster. Right wing. And Chassé deflects the puck in. It's McLean behind the net, clearing into the far corner. Anderson intercepts and is unable to center. Still has the puck. Plays it behind the goal, near side. Creighton races after the puck. He gets hit, but Hedekin bounces off of him into the corner for LaPerriere, trying to work in front. He's held by Babich. Down to the corner to Creighton. Holder moves to the net. Creighton, a backhand shot, and it's caught and held by Kirk McLean. Good work by the big veteran, Adam Creighton.
A great job of penalty killing by the Blues, killing off the five-minute major to LaPerriere, and then they go right back to work five on five. They've got the forecheck going. Creighton with the last shot just twirls around and on the backhand lets the shot go, and McLean is able to make the save. But that's an excellent shift. After killing the penalty, they put pressure on, they forecheck, they kept turning the puck back and putting pressure on the Vancouver Canuck defense.
The Canucks had, I believe, three shots and no more on that power play. They really didn't get that many shots. And the shots now are 10-8 in the game, Vancouver. Bodies falling every which way in the Canuck zone. Along the boards, Hunter tied up. Puck goes to the corner. It's centered. And it's intercepted by the youngster, Mark Watton. His pass, finally Ruttu tips the puck out. And it's shot back in by McInnes. Good pressure by the Blues. Oh, McInnes taken down at center ice by Tim Hunter and injured. McInnes is injured at center ice. Tim Hunter took him down. And now from afar, Terry Gregson is going to call a penalty. He was well into the Vancouver end and may well just be guessing at what happened, but he's going to penalize Tim Hunter. There's a break in the action. Second period at Kiel. It's 1-1. And this is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Al McInnes on the Blues bench seems to be still hurting from the elbow he took from Tim Hunter, who gets a penalty on the play. And the Blues will have a power play.
3:02, second period. Time of the penalty. 1-for-4 are the Blues in the power play. Canucks get the puck in their own zone, and Lume clears it the length of the ice. Lume and Merzen, Ruttu and Jeff Kortnoff killing the penalty for Vancouver. Duchesne leads the attack for the Blues. Up to the red line. He'll shoot the puck in near corner behind the net. McLean leaves it for Lume. He winds her up, cranks the puck off of Holder and into the Blues players' bench, and we'll have a faceoff. Let's pause here. 5 seconds for station identification. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
And thus far, this has been the type of game where both teams have found themselves shorthanded, or we've seen some four-on-four throughout the course of the game, and there hasn't ever been any type of rhythm established in this game. But just a couple of shifts of even strength in this game thus far.
Now Norton works in with a bouncing puck, then gets checked, and the puck in the corner. Here's Shanahan centering, hits the side of the net, and McLean whacks it away. Merzen up the far side, too far. And McInnes shoots the puck in. Blues onside. Ellick into the corner. Tied up by Lume. Leaves the puck for Jeff Norton. Norton stick handling. Along the near boards. To the point to Hull. Far point to McInnes. Looking for traffic. There's none in front. Not a Hull. Left point. Norton in front. Ellick. He can't deflect the puck on net. Centers for Hull. Tipped away. Norton a blast. And an arm and blocker save by McLean. And the puck over the glass into the crowd. That time Hull was out at the blue line much of that time, and actually three Blues out at the line.
Well, Hull did a good job going back because Norton had pinched in, and then they moved the puck around. Good pass from Norton all the way across the ice, and Todd Ellick, who had a chance to one-time the pass, let it go and couldn't get good wood on it, and eventually the shot will come from Norton back at the left point again, and an easy play, or an easy save, I should say, for Kirk McLean.
Just under 1 minute remaining in the Tim Hunter penalty. The Blues and Canucks tied at one. 4:04 gone in the second. Big crowd here at Kiel. Face off in the Vancouver end. The battle for the puck. It comes in front. Tips over the stick of Shanahan. He'll dig it out of the corner to Hull. On the near boards. Hull tees it up. He shoots well wide. Right point, McInnes. Near point to Norton. He has trouble with the puck. Has to shoot it into the corner behind the net for Shanahan. Far side for Ellick. He's knocked down by Christian Ruttu. He'll work up the far wing to the red line. Canucks shorthanded. Long shot. He scores from center ice. Christian Ruttu over the red line. Lets one go shorthanded and beats Curtis Joseph. And the Canucks get their fourth shorthanded goal of this playoff series.
Ruttu obviously surprised Joseph. He just gets over the red line and lets the shot go. Joseph was able to see it all the way. There was no screen on the play as McInnes went off to the side to let him shoot it. And that just beat Joseph. Joseph went down on the play. I'm not even sure if he touched it. It looked like he might have got just a little piece of it. And it goes off the post. Maybe not. I think he missed it completely. And it gets behind him. And that has quieted this crowd as Vancouver leads it 2-1.
4:31, route to the shorthanded goal. Now a breakaway, Jeff Courtnall, he's in alone. He shoots, he scores! Back-to-back shorthanded goals for Vancouver. First route to, now Jeff Courtnall. And the Blues trail it 3-1. Two shorthanded goals, five in the series for the Canucks.
The puck just came around and Courtnall picked it up. No one there, and he lets a quick shot go to the far side. And just inside the post, Jeff Courtnall, after taking that vicious hit from LaPerriere earlier, back in the play. And the quick wrist shot beats Joseph. And boy, oh boy, five shorthanded goals in the series. That's killing the Blues.
Two shorthanded goals in the span of 17 seconds. And now the Blues are in serious trouble. 5 minutes into the second period, game five. Now Russ Courtnall steals on a shot at Joseph the save. And the penalty to Tim Hunter is over. At center ice, Norton shoots it in. Blues trail it 3-1. If they lose this one, they'll have to win two in a row. Next game, Wednesday night in Vancouver. Right point, McInnes, a shot goes wide. Pinching in, here's Norton. Into the corner, fending off Merzen. Then he's stripped by Merzen. Stick gets away. And the puck cleared by Lume, not out. Right point, shot by McInnes, knocked down by Lume. And it's a 3-on-2. Lume into the blue zone. Russ Courtnall goes to the bench. Here's a shot right on. And Joseph makes a save. Back the other way, McInnes. Long pass for Tekin and skips away. Loose puck at center ice. Now it's Ojek. Gino Ojek can't get a shot. Stopped by McInnes, taken out behind the net. Norton clears up the boards, not up. Bure wheels and shoots wide. Chassé back in his own end, gets the puck, plays it around behind the net. Then Gilbert is checked by Bure. Here's Linden wheeling and shooting. Out the far point, that shot going wide. Cullimore to Bure in the corner. Now in front, Ojek, a shot! Oh, and Joseph the save. Now the Blues start up ice. McInnes to Tiikkanen. Over the red line, and he shoots the puck in, and the Blues are changing. And Chassé sandwiched behind the Vancouver net. Big hit by Shanahan. Oh, he's going to get a penalty. Brendan Shanahan will get a charging penalty. Then Chassé attacked behind the net by Cullimore and Alex Stoyanov. And the officials come in there. Holder grabs one of the Canuck players. And LaPerriere is in the middle of it also. He is having words with Mark Watton. But the importance here, two shorthanded goals by Vancouver to give them a 3-1 lead. And now the Blues will be shorthanded.
Well, the reason he's going to give Shanahan a penalty, I believe, is because when Shanahan went in for the hit on Cullimore, he jumped. He left his feet on the play. And I believe that's why Gregson is making the call. Boy, the Blues have gotten themselves in trouble. It all happened behind the net. Shanahan will come into the play. And he jumps and leaves his feet. It wasn't much of a hit on Cullimore, who is 6'5" and 220 pounds, but he left his feet on the play.
On the goals, Rutu, his first unassisted, shorthanded at 4:31. And then at 4:48, Jeff Courtnall's second unassisted. Another shorthanded goal to make it 3-1. And the Blues in serious trouble here in the second period of Game 5 with a series of best-of-seven affair tied at 2 victories aside.
And you can just feel not only the crowd, but the Blues and the Canucks, a big difference in the last 3 or 4 minutes in the play. After Vancouver took the 2-1 lead, that seemed to give them a jump. The Blues now seem to be a little bit off balance, a little confused, standing around wondering, you know, exactly what to do. They've got to get things back going again and in a hurry.
Barron shoots the puck in. A 2-minute charging penalty to Shanahan, creating a power play for Vancouver. Blue made a center ice around Hull. Shoots the puck in. Jassé and Cullimore also get two for roughing. At 6:25, Blues get the puck and clear at the length of the ice. So Bure, Rutu, and Jeff Courtnall have scored for Vancouver. Hull has the Blues goal. Still over 13 minutes to go in the second period. Jeff Courtnall feeds across the ice on the near wing. Ronning works in, cuts to the middle. Now a pass off Jeff Courtnall, and Carbono clears it out. Hull has a breakaway over the blue line. Moves in. He fakes. He waits. He shoots. McLean makes a great save to Rob Hull, trying to score shorthanded on a breakaway. Big turning point. Now Bure and Carbono fencing at center ice. Away from that action, Jeff Courtnall breaks in to Linden. Cutting in. Backhand shot and a save. And then Bure takes a run. There'll be a penalty. He takes a run at Duchesne. And there'll be a penalty against Pavel Bure, who moments earlier at center ice was fencing with Guy Carbono, who comes over to him now and has a few words. I told you so. Boy, did Brett Hull have an opportunity moments ago.
And Kirk McLean just simply outweighs Hull. Hull's going to fake the shot, try and get McLean to move, and he doesn't. He just stays with him all the way, follows him, and by the time Hull had a chance to shoot from the other side, there was nothing to shoot at. McLean just plays it perfectly, and he shut everything off on Brett Hull on the breakaway and made the save. Hull going to his right. Boy, McLean goes on. There's nothing to shoot at. There's nothing to shoot at. He stayed very patient, waited for Hull to make the move, and stayed with him, and Brett didn't have anything to shoot at.
Talking with Brendan Shanahan, who had 3 on Saturday night in Vancouver against McLean before the game tonight, Brendan said, man, he's tough because he outweighs you. He says, oftentimes the key to scoring goals is be patient. But he says, you're patient with McLean, and he's more patient than you are.
Well, he showed it right there on the Hull breakaway.
Now to center ice. Creighton fires the puck in. Keekkonen gets it, works behind the net. Both teams are shorthanded here. Bure 2 for elbowing at 7:31, 4-on-4. Remember, in the first period, 4-on-4, the Canucks scored. Around Keekkonen, Babich into the offensive zone, a pass, and Duchesne intercepts. Under 12 to go in the second period. The Canucks, with a pair of shorthanded goals in a span of 17 seconds, have taken a 3-1 lead. Duchesne, right wing to Keekkonen. He'll take a shot off the blocker of McLean. Puck at the blue line. Trying to keep it in. McKinnessy can't. It's at center ice. Over the line. LaPerriere working to the right wing. Around Hedekin. In front. Loses his balance. And Ronning gets the puck. Here's Cliff Ronning flipping the puck far side. Hedekin at center ice for Vancouver. Just shoots the puck in. Now the Blues are at full strength. Shanahan back on. A power play. 54 seconds worth. McKinnis. Stick handles to the blue line. Al McKinnis to the red line. Blast the puck in. Around behind the net. Far side. Right back to McKinnis at the point. Now behind the net for Shanahan into the near corner. Blues set it up. Looking to get a goal back. Trailing by 2 to the blue line to Norton. Right point to McKinnis. Straight away to Norton. Right side McKinnis. He'll shoot. And that's kicked away. Here's Hull. Straight away to Norton. Right wing circle McKinnis. And a pass and no one there. Now Norton gets to the puck. Plays it ahead to Hull. 18 seconds to go in the power play. Far side for McKinnis. Now right point. Norton is shot and that deflects wide. And the Canucks come to center ice. Here's Trevor Linden. He'll just flip the puck in for the shorthanded Canucks.
Come on!
And Bure just about ready to come back on. Norton in his own end. Bure returns to the ice. Ferranek forechecking Norton. Puck left in the corner. McInnis sidesteps Jeff Cortnall. And a pass ahead, batted down. Berandi can't shoot the puck in. It's fought for along the near boards. Ellie Duke Gilbert and Greg Gilbert fires it in wide of the net. The Blues are changing. Jeff Cortnall, a pass knocked down by Ellick. Ellick, oh, over to Lidster. Puck goes high in the air. Gilbert, and then a shot and a save. I believe it was Hall who had the shot. Now Ellick behind the net trying to center. Baranek knocks the puck away. A battle behind the Vancouver net. Canucks player down. Puck comes loose. Here's Ellick in the near corner. Looking in front for Hall. He scores! Ellick from the corner! Oh, baby! Ellick scores! Bounds it in, I believe, off Kirk McLean. Looking for Hall in front. An errant pass, maybe. Or maybe just a smart move with Hall covered.
And McLean left the right post. McLean saw Hall move from the high slot into the other, move in close. And he'll just, McLean will end up on the right post. Ellick will end up with the puck in the corner. McLean will look to see where Hall is. And Ellick, after taking the time, you can see McLean just leave a little room on that side. And the puck goes off his pad and pass him. And that goal brings the Blues to within one at 3-2.
Now play resumes at center ice. Here's Bill Holder. Nice pass to Ellick. In over the line with Anderson. The puck knocked out to center ice. Hunter chips it ahead. This is Doug Lidster back in the St. Louis end. On defense with Holder. Ahead for Anderson. A pass for Ellick. Then he's well covered. Now Gilbert gets the puck. Greg Gilbert sends it into the corner. Banks behind the net. Ellick into the corner. Trying to center. Tied up. And Cliff running the other way. 9:18 to go in the second period. It's 3-2 Vancouver. Over to Lume, a drive and a pad saved by Joseph, but it's offside. The play offside. Now some shoving and bumping in the corner, but play is stopped. 9:14 to go in the second period. The goal at 10:13. It's 3-2 Vancouver. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
The goal cam shows exactly what happened. Todd Ellick from the corner. The puck hits the side of the pad of goaltender Kirk McLean, who was leaving the post, and it gets in behind him, and the Blues are within a goal.
The puck deep in the St. Louis end. Norton a pass, misfires, and out at center ice, Jason Cullimore. He feeds off the far side, but the puck goes into the visiting player's bench. I guess on the Vancouver side, they're saying that was a pretty bad goal. No question about it, a soft goal, but the Blues are thrilled to get it. Trailing by two at the time, giving up a pair of shorthanded goals within a span of 17 seconds to break a 1-1 deadlock.
They've exchanged soft goals because certainly the first shorthanded goal by Vancouver was extremely soft, just over the red line.
Now a false start at center ice. We'll have the faceoff again. Hall and Ellick have scored for the Blues. Bure, Rutu, and Jeff Cortnall for the Canucks. 9:02 to go. Second period faceoff at center ice. Jason Cullimore with a puck. On defense with Dave Babich. Loses it at center ice. Norton shoots it in. Norton is on with Duchesne, Roberts, Creighton, and Tiikkanen up front. Up the near side. Hatsuda. He's checked. Puck in the Blues end. Rutu can't get it. Blues clear it out. Here's Babich at his own line. Now to Hatsuda. Started the year with Edmonton. He's well covered. Tiikkanen steals the puck. And he'll flip it in. After it is Creighton. He's hit by Cullimore before he gets near the puck. And it comes behind the net near side for Rutu. He gets hammered by Tiikkanen. Out of his own end, the veteran Dave Babich. Babich into the Blues end. Puck knocked away. Into the corner, Jeff Norton. Up the boards for Tiikkanen. Hatsuda tries to steal and does. Then he gets checked, but still has the puck. Sends it in front. Joseph knocks it away. Linden. Now to Lume. Top of the left wing circle. Lume fakes, works in. Then a pass goes behind the net. Here's Linden, near side. Traffic. The shot. It's blocked. Another shot, and it tips behind the net. And Norton is checked. Here's Dave Roberts. And he clears the puck out as he takes a hit from Momesso. Lume at the Vancouver line. Works near the red line. They give him the red line. Shoots it in wide. Jeff Norton back for the puck. Loses his balance. And here's Denny Chassé. Hit by Linden. Passes to center ice. And Tiikkanen shoots the puck in. Both teams are changing. McLean leaves the puck behind his net. Here's your King Lume. Up the middle it comes. Out to center ice. Ajek gives the puck to Ronning. Back for Ajek, too far. He's behind the net. Feeds around near side. Shanahan is there. Gives it to McInnes. McInnes leads the attack for Chassé. Pass rejected. Now Barron. He can't work in. Here's Gino Ajek sending the puck right in front of his net. Played by Lume. And he clears to center ice. Barron feeds over far wing for Hull, and he'll shoot it in. 7:05 left in the second. 3-2 Vancouver. Canucks to Bure. Then a pass hits Hull. Hull keeps it in. Feeds in front to Shanahan. Shanahan is checked and breaking out Bure. He's hooked down by Hull. And Barron gets the puck and flips it into the Vancouver end. This is Cliff Ronning. Right wing to Bure. He'll pass in the middle to Lume at the red line, and he'll shoot it in. And Vancouver's changing on the fly. This is Al McInnes for St. Louis. Far wing for Hull, who's lost his helmet. Hull over the blue line. Hull, bad angle, a shot, pad, save! Oh, the rebound is knocked wide. And the Canucks start out. Here's Hedekin, slowed up by Hull. Boy, Hull with a big hook. Now far wing, Russ Courtnall to Hedekin. Good chance in front for Jeff Courtnall. A puck tipped away. McRae can't clear it out. Jeff Courtnall, a shot. Blocked by Carboneau. Blues still can't get the puck out. And finally, Holder ahead to McRae. Stick handling in around Russ Courtnall. Into the corner, centers, and right under the stick of Joseph Beranek. Beranek checked by Hull. At center ice, Babich left wing to Jeff Courtnall, and the Canucks are rather Russ Courtnall, and play stop. We've got an offside, and bodies tumbling every which way. How's the crowd like it? They're making noise. They're on their feet, and what a performance by Brett Hull. Body checking at every spot on the ice. Late in the second, Canucks 3, the Blues 2. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Well, the Blues have tried to get more physical and get this crowd into it. Brett Hull takes down Bure on the far side, loses his helmet, had a scoring chance, and he comes back after Joseph Beranek, takes him out of the play, and the crowd really got into it after the hit by Brett Hull, and Basil McRae then was next on the ice. It was an offside, but a late whistle, and McRae coming across, trying to take a run at Russ Courtnall. Russ Courtnall right at the last second. Looked up, saw McRae coming, and said, I better get out of the way, and did.
And on the play, Glenn Anderson picks up a two-minute roughing penalty. Blues are shorthanded, 14:04 the time of the penalty. Gomeso slides the puck ahead out of Beranek's reach. McInnes behind the net, plays it off the glass, and by Bure. Hull after the puck, but Lume back in the Vancouver zone ahead of him. Hull carries on, tries to knock Lume down and can't. Lume with a puck. Vancouver has the man advantage. They're 0-for-2 in the power play. At center ice, the puck to Russ Courtnall. His pass hits a skate. 5:22 to go in the second period. Shorthanded are the Blues and down 3-2. Both teams have two wins in this best of seven Western Conference quarterfinal series. Barron checks Beranek. Bure can't work in. He's at center ice. At the red line, a pass over to Momesso. He'll carry back in his own end. Keep in mind, the Canucks have the power play. Far wing, Beranek. He can't shoot it in. Knocked down by Duchesne. Boy, what a job the Blues are doing here, killing the penalty. Bure at center ice, far wing to Linden. Puck gets away. Duchesne can't clear. And there to get it is Barron, clearing it up the near boards. Kept in by Bure. Tipped away by Shanahan and cleared the length of the ice by Barron. 40 seconds to go now in the Vancouver power play. They're looking to add to a 3-2 lead in the second period. Ronning to Dave Babich in the center circle. Right wing for Jeff Courtnall in the Blues end. Flips the puck to the corner. Norton checked by Linden. They buy for the puck. Norton pushes it up the boards. Bure pinches in, gets hit, and Norton clears the puck out. Ellick beaten to it by Babich in the Vancouver end. Ellick falls down. Has to hurry back. Long pass. Offside. Offside, Jeff Courtnall. Then he takes a swing from Norton. Then he sends a left into Norton's face. I believe Norton took the first swing. Terry Gregson judiciously will probably send both to the penalty box. The emotions are high here at Kiel with 4:07 remaining in the second period.
Well, Vancouver has had some good results with the long pass. David Babich to Courtnall, and that was another close call.
That was very, very close. The question is, was Jeff Courtnall on the blue line as the puck went over the line?
The long pass from Babich. He gets to the blue line. A very close call right up the middle of the ice. Ooh.
May have been on the line still. May have been onside, but the official called it offside.
And that's something that has led to so much success for Vancouver in this series. The Blues were able to shut that down in game four. Vancouver has had more success with the breakaways and the long passes in this game tonight. Another look at the long pass. Boy, it looked onside. I don't think there's any question that the right skate of Jeff Courtnall was on the blue line as he took the pass from David Babich.
Now the faceoff outside the Vancouver blue line. 12 seconds to go in Glenn Anderson's penalty. The Canucks control in their own end. They lead this game 3-2. Led it 1.3-1. It's Ronning ahead to Linden. He overskates. McInnis clears the puck out. And the penalty is over to Glenn Anderson. Now the play is offside, but a delayed call. Babich, a pass touched by a Blues player, and the offside is called. 3:47 left. Period two, 3-2, Vancouver. This is St. Louis Blues hockey. AutoZone presents our Blues playoff point leaders. Brendan Shanahan, 3 goals, 5 assists, 8 points. Ellick and McInnis, 5 points each. Hull and Duchesne, 4 points. Our Blues leaders brought to you by the AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts. Ken Wilson, Joe Micheletti, Bruce Affleck at Kiel. Late in the second period at center ice, McRae intercepts, forces the puck into the Vancouver end. And the Canucks try to work out Du up the near wing, Ruutu. He'll flip the puck towards the goal. Joseph out of the crease, plays it behind the net, near corner for Carboneau. Ruutu all over him. The puck springs to McInnis. He clears it up. McRae forces it to center ice, and it comes loose to Hull. Hull over the line with Carboneau. In front of Carboneau, looking for a deflection. He cannot quite get his stick on it. Puck still on the Vancouver end. Here's Carboneau in the corner. Out in front. Shot! He scores! Bill Holder! Bill Holder! And the Blues have come roaring back to tie it at 3. Oh, baby! What a heads-up play there! Coming out of the near corner. What a play!
And Holder was coming off the bench. Hull was going to the net. That drew the back checker with him. And what a pass from Carboneau. Hull going to the net. That left a lane back to Holder, who walked in. And Holder let go a quick shot. A Vancouver player sliding in front of him might have distracted McLean. And the goal by Holder ties it at 3.
What a headsy play by Guy Carboneau out of the corner. 16:56, the time of Holder's first goal. It's tied at 3. Now the Canucks, Beranek shoots the puck in. Lidstrom back to play it. Ojic gets in the way in the corner. Russ Courtnall out to the blue line to Lume on his backhand. Sends it wide of the net. Loose puck behind the Blues goal. Holder there takes a man. Now Lidstrom slaps the puck up the boards. Shanahan tied up. Russ Courtnall at the blue line. And the puck tipped to center ice. LaPerriere, ooh, right wing feed just out of the reach of Chassé. He's taken into the boards heavily by Merzant. Around the near side, Shanahan one hand on the stick. And then Barron pokes the puck ahead. Chassé has it at the blue line. A pass ahead, Lume intercepts. Flips the puck far side. And it's shot in. And Chassé takes out Ojic. Back to get the puck. Joseph up to center ice. McInnis up the near wing to Gilbert, but hold everything across the way. Gino Ojic and Denny Chassé. I mean Chassé trying to take Ojic as the play went into the blue zone. Up about 5 rows. And they ended up in a wrestling match. But trust me, Chassé was the aggressor.
Chassé, first of all, goes into the corner. He takes a hit to make a play. Dana Merzant takes him into the boards. And then Chassé came back together with Gino Ojic. That was one thing that Rick Lee wanted his team to do in this game. He wanted the big guys to play bigger. Ojic, who had been out with a torn stomach muscle playing in his first game of the series, and he has been throwing his weight around as well tonight.
Chassé goes off along with Ojic, matching penalties here. with 2:06 to go in the period. A very physical game, as you would expect here in game five. Probably the biggest story is the fact that shorthanded in this period, the Canucks were able to score two goals in 17 seconds on Joseph. The first of the two, a shot from just over the red line along the ice by Christian Ruutu. And then 17 seconds later, a goal to make it 3-1. Now Ellick and Holder have come back to tie it, but it hasn't been easy. Now the Blues control in their own end. Chassé high sticking. Ajik gets roughing at 17:54. Here's Tikkanen on the right wing. Over the line. Quick shot. Save. Rebound. Owen Hall. Tied up by Babbitts. And a great check by Hall. Here's a shot. Duchesne to save. What a check on Linden. Right wing side. Tikkanen a shot stop. Tikkanen with a puck again. It's 4-on-4. Right point. Hall a shot. Right on. And McLean the save. And he clears the puck out all the way back into the St. Louis end. Oh, what a job Brett Hull has been doing with his body, especially here in the second period. Blues shoot the puck the length of the ice right on goal. Canucks in their own end. Lume up to Linden, gaining speed at his own line. Linden to the red line. Linden left wing to Hedekin, back to Bure. He has to curl, puts the puck to Lume. He's checked by Deacon and sliding it into the corner. McInnes. Al McInnes in front of his net, up at the red line to Shanahan. Partial break. Hedekin back. Shanahan shoots. And McLean robs Shanahan with just over a minute to go in the second period. Look out. Here's Bure with skating room through center ice with Ronning trying to get around McInnes. And a little bouncing shot stopped by Joseph. McInnes ahead for Shanahan. Remember, Shanahan and Hull in this game have both been stopped on breakaways. Big hit Cullimore on LaPerriere. And Russ Courtnall back in his own end to get a loose puck. Russ Courtnall up the near boards, overskates the puck, and Babbitts clears it out. Doug Lidster ahead to LaPerriere, who scoops it in. Half a minute to go in the second period. The Blues and the Canucks are tied at 3 in game 5. Babbitts advances the puck to Ronning through center ice. Right wing pass, hits a skate the other way. It's LaPerriere over the line with Hull, but Hull moves in over the blue line ahead of the puck. And the Blues are offside with 15 seconds to go in the period and 8 seconds to go in the penalties to Ajek and Chassé.
What a pass from Al McInnes from deep in his own zone, just to the right of Curtis Joseph. A long pass to Shanahan, who took the pass just at the red line, moved in. He tries to beat McLean with the quick shot, and McLean was able to get down. Boy, that puck nearly slid underneath his pad. Shanahan with the quick shot, and that puck was already partially underneath the right pad of McLean before he got a piece of it, and the puck just slithered off to the right side of the net.
15 seconds to go in the period. Hall, Ellick, and Holder have scored for the Blues. Bure, Ruutu, and Jeff Courtnall for Vancouver. Two of their goals coming shorthanded. In 5 games, they've scored 5 shorthanded goals. Here's Holder falling down. But the Blues get the puck. Hall races up the right wing. He's inspired. Shot! And a save by McLean. 5 seconds to go. The penalized players are on. And a shot deflects up into the crowd. And with 2.5 seconds to go in the second period, play is stopped. Hey, hockey fans, get over to Metro Lighting and cool off with Emerson Attic Fans and Ceiling Fans, priced to sell right now. That's at Metro Lighting.
And now Mike Keenan pulling Curtis Joseph out of the net with 2.5 seconds left to go in this second period. They'll try to win the faceoff, which is deep in the Canucks zone. They'll try to win the faceoff and get one more scoring opportunity before the end of the second period.
In this period, the Blues have outshot Vancouver 15-8, but those two shorthanded goals have killed the Blues. It's Carboneau, Shanahan, LaPerriere, Tikkanen, Hull, and McInnes. Well, they've got some firepower out there.
They do, and now they need to win the faceoff.
LaPerriere could head for the net. Carboneau will try to win the draw to either Tikkanen or McInnes or Hull or anybody else. But the draw won by Baranek, and the puck cleared down the ice, and that is the end of the second period. Well, wasn't that some period? The two shorthanded goals, Ruutu and Jeff Courtnall, to make it 3-1 Vancouver, and then Ellick and Holder come back to tie it. After 40 minutes of Stanley Cup playoff action at Keele Center, It's the Blues and Canucks tied at 3. Coming up here in our second intermission, Bruce Affleck will chat with Vancouver captain Trevor Linden. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey. Welcome back to Kiel Center, where after two periods, the Canucks and Blues are tied at 3. Ken Wilson, and we apologize that Trevor Linden will not be joining us, but it gives Bruce Affleck and I a chance to reflect on that period. Two was important. There were two shorthanded goals by Vancouver and two Blues breakaways, Hull and Shanahan, that McLean was able to stop. Bruce, first, let's talk about the two shorthanded goals and Ruutu scoring the first from just over the red line.
Well, Ken, you know, statistics can lie, obviously, in the Vancouver Canucks all season long only had 7 shorthanded goals. They've got 5 in the series in 5 games, so that's kind of surprising. Of course, the Blues only gave up 2 all year long. Now they've given up 5 in this series. So, you know, some people say it's tough to figure out Mike Keenan. It's tough for me to figure out how this is happening. But, you know, the long shot from Ruutu, of course, hurt the Blues definitely. You'd expect goaltending in both Joseph in this case and, of course, the McLean in Vancouver's case let in a soft goal in that period. And it really hurt the Blues, of course, being shorthanded in that sense. So, you know, it's especially from a shot outside the blue line like that, you would think Curtis would have had it. Maybe he just thought it played it too simply almost, and it certainly hurt the Blues. And then, of course, 17 seconds, I think, later, the Vancouver Canucks come back and get another shorthanded goal.
Yeah, and the Blues were in a bit of a funk. It reminded me a little bit of the days they were in the first period of Game 3 in Vancouver. But the Blues came back, and that's something they have had the ability to do all season, in single games when they were down, and in a series of games when they were struggling, as they were Saturday night in Vancouver, when they were able to turn it around and come back. And Bruce, soft goals. What about the Ellick goal from the corner? A terrible play, really, by Kirk McLean.
Well, again, soft goaltending. You know, you expect goaltending to be so good in the playoffs, and it hasn't happened, really, in this series in that sense. And I guess it's eye for an eye, almost. But, yes, a soft goal, no question, from Todd Ellick from the side. How important is it to put the puck on net? We saw it. This period, obviously, 2 soft goals. So, you know, as you look at it, the Blues come back, though, as you mentioned, Ken, and they did it at even strength, and they've done that all year long. They were one of the best teams in the National Hockey League at 5-on-5, and that's what it took for the Blues to get back in this game. So, you know, I think they've got some momentum going into the third period. Very important 20-minute segment, obviously, coming up for the St. Louis Blues if they want to retain home ice advantage.
All right, Bruce, thanks very much. We're in the second intermission, Game 5 of this best-of-7 Western Conference quarterfinal series, tied at 3. When we come back, we'll have more from Kiel Center. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey.
A wild second period at Kiel Center as Vancouver took a 3-1 lead on 2 goals, coming shorthanded. The Blues come back and get 2 themselves, and we're tied after 2 periods of play. St. Louis Blues Hockey is brought to you by Ford. The introduction of Ford Windstar established the whole new standard for minivans. See and test drive the new Ford Windstar soon at your St. Louis quality Ford dealer on both sides of the river. By Ameritech, your link to better communications. And by Circuit City, what's right for you at the right place, right place, right now. Tonight's NHL Notebook brought to you by your neighborhood Chrysler Plymouth dealer. It's a fact. 3 different teams have won the Stanley Cup the last 3 years. The last time 4 teams won in 4 years was 1941 to 1944. And the winners were Boston, Toronto, Detroit, and Montreal. Let's take a look at our Bush out-of-town scoreboard. Really, from the Eastern quarterfinal games yesterday, Philadelphia takes a 4-1 series win as they beat Buffalo 6-4. Lindros coming back, of course, leading the way with a goal and 2 assists. The other one that's over, New Jersey stuns Boston. In that series, they win it 4-1 with a 3-2 win in Game 5. First time to win the series in only 5 games for the Devils as they knock out the Bruins once again. In the quarterfinal, game number 5, Quebec takes it to the New York Rangers. They stay alive. They beat the Rangers 4-2. As the Quebec Nordiques stay alive, they will be in New York tomorrow night. And the other game in overtime, Pittsburgh with a 6-5 victory. Capitals still lead that series 3-2. In that game, Francis, Jágr, and Stevens combined for 11 points on 5 goals and 6 assists. Meanwhile, in the Western Conference, Dallas stays alive. The other night,
as the Wings lead that series 3-1. But in the third period, Detroit leads 2-1. They could wrap that series up tonight. The other game, Chicago shutting out Toronto in the second period, 2-0. That series at 2 games apiece. Seems like every team wins it on the road. Meanwhile, Calgary has a 1-0 lead in the first period at home against San Jose. That series also tied 2 games apiece. And again, Fleury, the big star in that game with 4 goals the other night. Well, the score here, 3-3 after 2 periods of play. We'll come back and look at second period highlights. And it was a wild second period with Ken and Joe when we come back. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey.
Welcome back to Kiel Center just prior to the start of the third period, and this game is tied at 3. Along with Joe Micheletti, Ken Wilson. First period, Bure and Hull score. Second period, the Blues get stunned. The first goal, that long Christian Ruutu shot.
That was ugly. Christian Ruutu shorthanded on the play. Just carries the puck over the red line. Now Al MacInnis, the Blues defenseman, he gets out of the way so Joseph can see the shot. And the long shot just beats him. Now, he might have gotten a little piece of it. I don't think so, though. It beats him, and that shorthanded goal made it 2-1.
17 seconds later, Jeff Courtnall scores.
He comes in from the right side, and the Blues hadn't recovered from the other shorthanded goal, and Courtnall with the quick shot to the far side. Joseph went down at just inside the post, and quickly everyone is stunned, and it's 3-1 Vancouver.
And that ties a playoff record, 5 shorthanded goals in a series by a team. Then the Blues get a break. Todd Ehlick from the corner.
And this is an ugly one as well. Both goaltenders had played well last game. This time they landed a couple of soft ones. Ehlick from the corner just fires it out in front of the net. Now McLean, watch him come off the post. He just leaves a little opening off the post. It hits his pad and goes in behind him, and the Blues make it 3-2.
And then less than 2 minutes later, the Blues tie it.
On the play, Bill Holder is coming off the bench. A good job of forechecking and keeping the puck in. And then Guy Carboneau, the veteran, picks it up. Hull is going to the net, so he brings one man with him. That leaves Holder all alone, and Holder with a quick wrist shot beats McLean to the short side, and that tied the game at 3.
So on our summary, Ruutu's first unassisted. Jeff Courtnall second unassisted. Ehlick gets the goal at 10:13 from Gilbert. Holder scores his first. They give it to Carboneau and Hull, but I believe it was McCrail on the boards who set up Carboneau. Shots 15-8 in that period for the Blues, who are out shooting Vancouver. The period summary brought to you by Discover Card. It pays to discover the card that pays you back. We're headed to the third in pivotal game number 5, and it's tied at 3. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey. Well, we are set to go with the third period, and it's 3-3. On the Jeff Courtnall shorthanded goal, it made it 3-1. Add assists to Merzen and Lume. On the Ehlick goal, Gilbert the assist. So you're up to date on the scoring and play underway. Both teams at full strength. And the puck in the Vancouver end. Canucks control. Puck shot out by Hodgick. Shot back in by the Blues. And here's Merzen. Far side to Lume. Pass ahead for Hodgick, tipped away. Puck goes to the Blues goal, trying to clear Joseph. Merzen shoots the puck wide. The Blues chase after it. Lume pinches in the corner to Linden. Then he'll clear the puck ahead for Bure. Right point, Lume. Shot right on Joseph. The save on a rebound by Hodgick wide. Then Carboneau ties up Bure. Gino Hodgick takes a shot, and the puck goes wide. And Hull gets the puck, feeds it into the middle to Creighton. Creighton over the Vancouver line, has Merzen on his back. Then Lume in the corner steals the puck, clears it up the near side, and it's tipped by Hodgick right onto Chassé's stick. Great move around Merzen, 2-on-1. He fakes a shot, goes to the corner, gets tied up. Chassé held by Lume, a battle for the puck. It comes out to Jeff Courtnall, and he'll clear to center ice. To Bure over the line, a pass for Beranek, knocked away. Beranek beaten to the puck by Duchesne. He'll clear it to center ice, and here's Chassé. He'll fire the puck in. Out of the corner, it comes to LaPerriere behind the net, centering, and Hedekin intercepts. Quickly ahead, right wing for Russ Courtnall. Moving in on Norton, a pass to Beranek. He shoots and scores! Quick shot from well out, and Joseph Beranek beats Curtis Joseph Lowe, and the Canucks regain the lead 4-3.
Well, the Canucks quickly turned a chance by the Blues into a 3-on-2, and what a play by Russ Courtnell going down the right board. He turns a 3-and-2 into a 2-on-1, and then Baranek with the quick shot beats Joseph through the legs, and that makes it 4-3 Vancouver.
Now Joseph goes to the bench, walks down the runway, and he's headed to the dressing room. And into the game will come John Casey very early here in the third period. A minute 37 in, Baranek scores from Russ Courtnell and Hedekin. And Mike Keenan makes the move. The crowd would seem to generally approve. John Casey enters the game.
Now, John Casey is a veteran of Stanley Cup experience. He's been to the finals with the Minnesota North Stars, of course, last year with the Boston Bruins, played a couple of rounds, and he has played a little over 10 minutes in this series as he relieved Curtis Joseph in game number two.
Now Joseph comes back by the bench after taking a long, long walk down the hall. Face off at center ice, Elecon with Gilbert and Anderson, Norton and Duchesne. Well, the Blues come back to their home ice where the Canucks have already won once, and they are having a struggle of it tonight. Here's Hedekin from the faceoff in his own end to Babich. Up front, Momesso, Ruutu, and Oksuda. Hedekin breaks into the Blues end and loses the puck, and Norton advances it out of the reach of Ellick. Dave Babich at the Vancouver line. Near side to Momesso at the red line. He'll shoot the puck in, and Casey plays it at the side of the net for Norton. Two forecheckers. Oksuda and Momesso, and the Blues break through. Ellick outlet to Duchesne through center ice into the Vancouver end. A pass away from Anderson. He'll tip the puck into the far corner. But Hedekin takes over. Skates up the wing. And behind the play, the net has come loose. The net behind Kirk McLean has come loose in 2 minutes and 15 seconds into the third period. Play is stopped. Baranek from Russ Courtnell and Hedekin at 1:37, breaking the tie.
And now the Blues need to do something to get the crowd back into the game. They need to either start hitting again, get some scoring chances. Remember, Kirk McLean, I think, has let in a couple of soft goals as well, and it just hasn't been a good night for Curtis Joseph at all. He has struggled. He let in the long shot, shorthanded, and then even the last goal, the 2-on-1, beats him through the legs. He, again, is fighting his confidence.
And the Blues are fighting the old saying, you can't win in the playoffs without good goaltending. They're going to try to come back and take a 3-2 lead in this best of seven series.
Again, we talked about that in the opening. One of the keys for the Blues was they needed good, solid goaltending. They haven't gotten it tonight.
Now the Blues intercept, and LaPerriere shoots wide. On with Shanahan and Chassé. Holder sends it behind the net. LaPerriere leaves the puck there. Chassé check. Now Shanahan, wraparound stop. He shoots, he scores! Second effort! He does it again! Brendan Shanahan stopped on the initial wraparound attempt. He hammers again, and McLean, who is not exactly having a glorious evening, looks up and says, huh, it's 4-4.
Well, this line with the two kids and Shanahan has been terrific the last two games. Shanahan, again, using his strength, tries to wrap it in once, gets his own rebound, and puts it in the far side past McLean to tie this game at 4. And again, the crowd is on their feet at the Kiel Center. Shanahan once, McLean beat apart a little bit, and Shanahan stays with it all the way to tie the game at 4.
2:32, the time of the goal. I'd hate to predict how this one's going to finish or what's going to happen between here and the finish. Canucks in their own end. LaPerriere hits Lume. This is Cullimore behind the Vancouver net. Linden, Ajic, and Bure up front. A pass for Gino Ajic. From his side of the red line, he clears the puck the length of the ice. Back is Chassé to touch it. Icing is the call against Vancouver. Still early in the third, tied at 4. We pause 5 seconds for station identification. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey.
And Brendan Shanahan still involved with a couple of the Canuck players. Lume one, Cullimore another one out there. It was actually Lume and Shanahan that came together after the icing call, and they carried it on all the way from center ice back into the Vancouver zone and to the faceoff circle. Boy, Shanahan's got that glint in his eye, doesn't he?
From the faceoff, back to Shanahan. He works into the circle, shoots! Oh, McLean the save, and a rebound knocked away, and McLean looked none too confident.
He didn't know where it was.
Now the Canucks at center ice, a pass too far. Casey at the side of the net, leaves the puck. McInnes clears it up and out to center ice and all the way back into the Vancouver end. Shanahan was injured. Shanahan can't get up to leave the ice. Shanahan injured, favoring his right leg. Hobbles to the bench, back the other way. Linden a shot, and it's kicked away by Casey, going off the net in front. Oh, and Jeff Courtnall shoots wide. Here's Carbonell. Shanahan's in bad shape on the bench. Puck to center ice. Babbitt shoots it in. Duchesne ahead. And the Blues watch the Canucks shoot the puck back in. Shanahan got hit at mid-ice in his own end. Now the Canucks from center ice dump the puck in. This crowd is stunned. Shanahan injured, leaving the ice. Tiikkanen from his own blue line shoots the puck the length of the ice. And there'll be an icing call here against the Blues, and a lot of players unhappy, screaming at each other. What's happened to Brendan Shanahan? That's the question. 4-4 the score. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Brendan Shanahan and Gino Ogic get tied up together. Now the right skate, the right foot of Shanahan comes together with the left skate of Ogic, and you could just see his ankle turn over as he was going down. It didn't give on the ice at all. And he was in a lot of pain as he went to the Blues bench and then to the dressing room.
Oh, the ups and downs of the playoffs. Creighton a pass off a Canuck player center ice. Duchesne shoots the puck in. McLean out of the crease, plays it up the far side for Russ Courtnell on with brother Jeff, who takes a pass at the red line. Baranek the other forward. Nice poke check by Duchesne. Then Hedekin check. A battle for the puck right below us. And Baranek has it in the center circle. Around Hull. Over the blue line. Around Tiikkanen. Baranek in front for Jeff Courtnell in the pass by him. Here's Steve Duchesne. Blues on the attack. Ahead to Hull with Tiikkanen. And Duchesne 3-on-3 to Tiikkanen. Back for Hull. The pass behind him. This is Brett Hedekin. Hedekin for Vancouver. 15-12 to go in the third. It's 4-4. Right wing to Baranek. He'll fire the puck in. The Canucks are changing. The Blues having to go it without Brendan Shanahan, whose tying goal at 2:32 here in the third period got the crowd back in it for a moment. Merzen shot blocked. Hull breaks out. Then he's poke checked by Merzen. And the Blues are caught for too many men on the ice. Holder and Lidster ended up on the ice at the same time. And the Blues are going to take a two-minute penalty here at 5:07 of the third period. Boy, this has been a rugged night for both sides.
Brett Hull had control of the puck in the neutral zone. It looked like the Blues were on a rush. And as soon as he went to make a move, the puck was poke checked off his stick by Dana Merzen right to the Blues players coming off the bench. There's all kinds of them out there, too many, and the Blues are shorthanded. That's an easy call for the linesman who's leaning against the boards in front of the Blues bench. This has been a crazy game. I mean, we're seeing all kinds of penalties and injuries and bad goaltending and a little bit of everything, something that I did not expect at all.
Remember, the Canucks in the second period got a pair of shorthanded goals in 17 seconds. They have scored 5 shorthanded goals in the 5 games of this series, tying an all-time NHL playoff record. In 83, the Oilers had 5 shorthanded goals. In 79, the Rangers did. So the Canucks have tied an all-time Stanley Cup record. Canucks have the puck in their own end on the power play. McRae serves the too many men on the ice penalty at 5:07. Lume works in, shoots the puck behind the net. Casey leaves it. McInnes screams it along the boards the length of the ice. Vancouver is 0-for-3 on the power play. They'd rather be shorthanded. Carbonell almost steals, and Lume gets the puck ahead to Linden at center ice. Now for Aksuda. Aksuda over the line, stick handling into the near corner, off the boards behind the net, far side, out to the right point. Here's Cliff Ronning advancing the puck. top of the right wing circle, side of the net, gets it back from Oksuda. Linden in front, Ronning fakes. Ronning well out, shoots, he scores! Cliff Ronning! And it may have been deflected, a long shot from a long way out by the blue line, skimming along the ice, a power play goal for Vancouver. They lead it 5-4.
The thing that makes it so difficult to defend against Ronning is you can't watch his eyes, because he'll look one way, pass the other, the same on the shot. He'll look somebody off, and then he'll end up taking the shot. Looks one way, just turns, he's quick, lets the shot go through Al MacInnis in front and underneath John Casey. And that power play goal now gives Vancouver a 5-4 lead.
Face off at center ice. The Blues holder tries to shoot the puck in. It's batted around, and now Chassé dumps it in. McLean leaves it for Hennekin. Up the middle it comes to Baranek. A pass knocked down. He tries again. Right wing to Russ Courtnell. He gets hit. Loose puck, Baranek. Jeff Courtnell in front. Then LaPerriere takes out Baranek. Holder gets the puck and clears it off Creighton to center ice. 5:56, Ronning's first playoff goal, a power play goal from Oksuda and Linden. Now the puck deep in the Vancouver end. It's a delayed offside. Blues put themselves onside. Up to Jeff Courtnell. He's through center ice into the Blues end. Right wing to Brother Russ, and a shot kicked out by Casey, who has replaced Joseph. Creighton gives the puck away, but Ruutu can't handle it. Not at center ice. Hedekin shoots it back in. I don't think this crowd of almost 19,000 knows quite what to make of this game. Chassé from center ice fires the puck in the corner. Gilbert can't handle it. Lume can't clear. Norton, a pass for LaPerriere, skips past him near corner. Here's Anderson behind the net for LaPerriere. Far side to Norton. Blues have some pressure. Then Norton gets checked. Loose puck on the near boards in the Canucks end for Momesso. He'll flip the puck in the air and over the glass and into the crowd to stop play. There's 12:41 to go in the third period. Vancouver 5, St. Louis 4. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey.
You have the view from John Casey's angle, the net cam. Casey trying to look through Al MacInnis. The puck goes right through MacInnis, past John Casey. That's the power play goal by Ronning that made it 5-4 Vancouver. On the way to a 7-6 game, aren't we?
Maybe 9-8. 12:41 to go, third period. What a pivotal fifth game this is, and what a strange one. Lume for the Canucks in his own territory. Sends the puck to center ice. Norton to Duchesne. Bouncing puck gets away. And it bounces to center ice. Gilbert picks it up. Races in on the right wing to the net. Anderson, a pass knocked away by Lume. Lume's played well in this series. Not a Ellick behind the net. Then it's poked away by Merzen. Norton pinches in, hit by Oksuda. Ellick battles for the puck. It comes to the blue line, kept in. Shot knocked down. And a drive by Norton over the net. Momesso leaves the puck behind his goal for Jurke Lume. He'll feed it up past Momesso and out at center ice. Duchesne controls. Shoots the puck right back in. 8 minutes have been played in the third period. And we have seen three goals. Two from Vancouver. They ice the puck, touched by Barron, and play stopped. And we'll have a faceoff back near Kirk McLean.
Well, the one thing that the Blues have been able to do in this game when they've fallen behind is generally they've come back out and either with a series of hits, forechecking, shots, and at times scoring a goal, have been able to turn this game and regain the momentum and get the crowd back into it. That's what they need to do now with the faceoff deep in Vancouver's zone.
Big hello to Ron Zirko and everyone at the store in Fairview Heights from Chris McMahon. Best wishes to Pete and Gene Bonham. They're moving to Detroit. Box and Shannon want to say hi to Vince and Dan. Also, happy birthday to Mike Rahal. Face-off in the Vancouver end. MacInnis a shot. Good stick save. Next shot hits the side of the net by Barron. Big scramble in front. Puck still loose. Pile up. Chassé's in the crease. Barron is up. He scores. It's good. Oh, baby, it's good. And the Canucks can't believe it, but Terry Gregson rules immediately that Dave Babich was holding Chassé in the crease. A very definitive call by the veteran referee, and Barron lets her rip from the left point, and the Blues have tied it at five.
Terry Gregson was behind the net, watching the front of the net the whole way. He saw Chassé get taken into the net, and then Babish won't let him go. The puck will end up back to the left point, and Babish won't let Chassé go. So a smart play. He just fires the puck, and it goes right through the legs of McLean, who looked to fall asleep on the play. Another bad goal.
He had a pretty good look at it.
He had a good look at it. He wasn't screened at all, but Barron did the right thing. Saw all the action in the crease and just decided to take the shot. McLean was waiting for the call and didn't get it.
We're back to live action, and Vancouver ices the puck. Oh, do you believe this one? It is 5-5 in game five. I don't know what McLean was doing.
Well, he was hoping that the referee would blow the whistle. Chassé goes in first. Now McLean is going to regain his senses and put himself in a position. Now it might have been that, well, he tried to get his legs together. I guess he just couldn't set himself. His left skate and the shin pad of Chassé kind of came together, and maybe he wasn't able to get himself back together, but he saw the shot, and I don't know what's going on.
This game is a true test of any analyst.
Did you include me in those 19,000 earlier?
Wow. Now the faceoff near McLean. It's 5-5. Puck goes behind the net. Lume feeds it up far wing past Russ Courtnall. Norton with a puck sends it to the net. Here's Roberts. A shot on it. Deflects over the net. Here's Dave Roberts in the corner. Bumped by Baranek. Baranek works behind his net. Gets tripped by Glenn Anderson, and there'll be a penalty call. Now a big pile up along the near boards and a bunch of shoving and wrestling. Anderson will get the original penalty. Oh, what a contest this has been. We're down to 11:03 to go, and anything may yet happen.
And that looked like a major league dive to me behind the net by Baranek. And Anderson, I think, is going to get an extra one. Or at least Gregson was looking at him while he threw the last punch. But behind the net, it looked like Joseph Baranek took the opportunity and took a dive. He first comes in, 42 is Baranek, and comes in on Roberts in the corner. Anderson will join the fray. And then Anderson, oh, I'm going to give him a 9.5. And he feels the stick on the right thigh, and then he'll just dive. I mean, he'll jump. He almost hurt himself. He jumped so high into the air and came down on the play. But I guess give him credit for drawing the penalty. Folks, it ain't over yet. 11:03 to go. Vancouver ends up with the power play.
Oh, boy. Dana Merzen's going to get a penalty. The Blues are going to end up with an extra penalty. We'll give them all to you. The crowd here, just shy of 19,000 tonight. And I think they're going to just sort of sit here until it ends. And I don't think anyone wants to guess how this one is going to come to a conclusion.
It might not end until 1 or 2 this morning, the way this is going.
Well, remember, Wednesday night, Game 6 in Vancouver. If Game 7 is necessary, it'll be here at Kiel Center Friday night. Tickets for Game 7 are on sale now at all of the usual Blues ticket outlets. Game 7 of this Best of 7 series Friday night at 7:30 here at Kiel. Now the crowd is incensed. Here are the penalties at 8:57. Anderson, 2 for tripping and a 10-minute misconduct. Merzen of Vancouver, Tiikkanen of St. Louis each get 2 for roughing. And the faceoff will be outside the Vancouver blue line when the Blues get ready. And they don't seem to be happy about it at all. And Terry Gregson goes over to the bench.
Ian LaPerriere, we had a chance as he's sitting on the bench. A couple of black eyes. He broke his nose in game 4 with an elbow by Jeff Courtnall. Now, meanwhile, Gregson back to the bench.
Rather animated conversation with Gregson and Keenan. Now Gregson goes over to talk to Coach Rick Lee. We have seen four goals in the period. Baranek, then Shanahan to tie it, Ronning, and then Barron to tie it from LaPerriere and McInnes at 8:22. Barron's first goal of the playoffs. And the Blues are shorthanded. Now some slashing right from the faceoff. Terry Gregson blows the whistle. He's red-faced. He says, look, I've had enough of this. You're out of here. Carboneau did some slashing. So did Ronning. And Terry Gregson has not, from the opening faceoff of the evening, wanted to let much of anything go.
Now, right off the start of this game, he was calling interference type of penalties, trying to keep the game under control, and now he is incensed. He is sending everyone off the ice at every little instance or altercation right off the faceoff. 21 is Guy Carboneau. He tries to hook Ronning. Ronning with the two-hand. Carboneau gives him a little bit of a slash back, and right away, Gregson makes the call. And now Anderson is heading to the Blues bench.
Usually the referees seem to keep their composure. You get the sense that Gregson is saying, look, this game is nothing special in terms of the way it's being played. It may mean a lot, but you guys aren't doing anything wonderful out here, and I'm sick and tired of this, and don't push me any further. Let's get this thing over with, and let's play hockey. McInnes at the red line fires the puck in. Carboneau and Ronning. 9:03, slashing penalties. Vancouver, Lume. Man, he's out there a lot. You talked about it earlier with Brown out. Up for Bure, tipped away. Then Hull gets the puck in his own end, clears it. The length of the ice. The Blues are shorthanded for another minute and a half. Now the Canucks up the ice. Here's Linden cutting to the middle over the blue line. He gets chopped down. Aksuda moves in. He's stopped by John Casey. Linden to the blue line to Lume. Far side to Bure. He's got a lot of room. He shoots, and Barron down to block the shot. Hull gets the puck. Can't clear. Bure near point. Lume. He shoots. Deflection. And Casey the save. A battle in the corner. The puck out in front. Blues can't clear it out. Then finally it's cleared to center ice. Boy, at times it looks like a good all-star peewee game.
Man. When?
Puck deep in the St. Louis end. Here's Norton. Of course, you got a bouncing puck the entire night, which we've seen all season, and this play is offside. Ellick over the blue line ahead of the puck. Boy, it's a shame the puck bounces all the time, and I try not to mention it because I know it's old news, but that keeps it from being a smooth, free-flowing game in many, many instances.
Well, I'm sure they're going to do something about that in the offseason because they've got it where it's about 23 below zero in here tonight, and it still hasn't really affected the ice in a positive manner. The puck's still bouncing and rolling, and even off the glass, there's no give. It rolls along the boards, and it makes it difficult, especially for the highly skilled players, to make the kind of plays that you need to make to be effective.
Norton fires the puck away to the ice. Oh, it bounces on McLean, and he makes the save. You don't think he had the shakes. Then LaPerriere tries to get in front, takes an elbow. Here's Russ Courtnall for Vancouver in his own territory. 9:18 to go in regulation play. Bure shoots the puck in. It's 5-5. Casey leaves it. And Norton fires the puck to center ice. Babich for Vancouver. The Blues shorthanded up to Baranek. Now to Momesso, to Russ Courtnall, to Baranek, and he can't center the puck. Now Tiikkanen back on. In front, oh, and Casey on a misplay by the Blues robs the Canucks. Here's Baranek, a shot, what a save, Casey. And Norton to Gilbert, who deflects the puck the length of the ice. Hedekin races back, touches it, and it's icing, and then Hedekin and Tiikkanen have words. 8:42 remaining in regulation action. Pivotal game five. It's 2-2 in the series and 5-5 in this game. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Well, Vancouver had a chance, a 2-on-1. Russ Courtnall with the setup. If you're watching on TV, look at the puck bouncing all over the place. A great defensive play by the ice to prevent a goal by Vancouver. And then John Casey was forced to come up with a couple of saves.
from the faceoff. The puck right to Casey, and he makes a quick save. Now the game at Joe Louis is over. Detroit has defeated the Dallas Stars 3-1, and the Red Wings move to the next round of the playoffs. They eliminate Dallas 4-1. And the Red Wings wait for their opponent.
They get a little bit of rest. Now they can take a couple of days off and then start getting ready for next Sunday.
Out in Calgary in the second period, the Flames lead the Sharks 3-0. Now the Blues work out. McInnes ahead to Hull over the red line. Shoots the puck in off the glass. Carabin behind the net. Near side, LaPerriere hit by Ajek. And the Canucks try to clear. Then McInnes, a shot! Stick save, McLean. And the puck, Ajek can't get it out. He's knocked down. And here's Hennigan working to center ice on a 4-on-3 to Babich. Slap shot! Caught by Casey. Hey, it's big news now when a goalie makes a save. Any kind of decent save, the crowd screams. Oh, what a game. 5-5, 8 minutes to go. The Blues shoot the puck the length of the ice. Hedekin back to touch it, and an icing call against the Blues. If the Blues win this series and Calgary eliminates San Jose, the Blues would play the Flames in the next round. Then Detroit would play the winner of Toronto-Chicago. That series, like the San Jose-Calgary series, 2-2. Chicago tonight at home, by the way, in the third period, leading the Maple Leafs 2-1.
Well, the Blues have fought back from deficits this entire evening. It almost seems, Ken, like maybe they should end up winning this game. The way they've been able to come back, they fall behind, a couple of shorthanded goals, they fought back, fought back, fought back. You get that gut feeling that maybe they deserve to win this.
Now Ronning centers. Bolmeso shoots wide from the faceoff. Lume keeps the puck in for Vancouver. Behind the net for Oksuda. He's big and strong. Centering. Norton clears the puck away. Here is Tikkanen. To the red line. He'll slap it in. Puck behind the Vancouver net. Cleared by Merzen. By Norton. No icing. Right to John Casey. He'll leave it for Jeff Norton. Norton starts up ice. Up to Roberts. Now to Tikkanen. He'll wind her up. A shot! And the save by McLean. Here's Dave Roberts in the corner. He gets checked. Wrestled down by Merzen. And a loose puck. Merzen finally there. But here's Creighton. He's checked by Ronning and Lume with it. Here's Kay Lume for Vancouver. That puck bouncing every which way. And finally, Tikkanen shoots it in. 7 minutes to go in regulation action in game five. And the Blues and Canucks tied at five. Vancouver clears the puck into the Blues end. Here's Murray Barron firing it off the far boards to center ice. Babich at the Vancouver line. Near side to Hedekin. He advances to the red line. Tries to shoot the puck in. Does work it in. And the puck in the blue zone. Controlled by McInnes. He'll flip it down the ice. This will be icing. Babich back to touch it. A whistle. And play stopped. 6:32 remaining in the third period. Recapping Bure and Hall's score in the first period. Hall's a power play goal. Ruutu and Jeff Courtnall shorthanded goals in the second period to make it 3-1 Vancouver. And then Ellick and Holder score to tie it. 3-3 going into the third. Baranek to give the Canucks the lead. Shanahan before his ankle injury ties it. Ronning a power play goal. And then Barron ties it at five. Our goal scoring recap brought to you by your Midwest GMC truck dealers, Bellman, Bomarito, and Brockland GMC. Brendan Shanahan not expected to return. The first indication from a distance show would be that it could be a fairly serious ankle injury.
Well, he had a lot of trouble getting off the ice.
From the faceoff, Blues control, Barron. He's on with McInnes, up to the red line. He'll take a shot, wide of the net. Chassé a blast over the net. Puck to the far side, Barron works in. Makes a nice play, but Baranek a pass out to Hedek, and he's wrestled down by Chassé. Barron slides the puck back in his own end to McInnes. A feed too far for LaPerriere. The puck the length of the ice. Hennigan touches it, and the Blues again are called for icing. This crowd tonight trying to do everything possible to cheer on the Blues. 18,907. They've made a lot of noise. They've been chanting, "Let's go, Blues. Let's go, Blues." And we're down to 6:06 remaining in regulation action.
And now if you get a chance to shoot the puck, forget the pass, especially with the goaltending the way it's been in this game, shaking most of the night. If the scoring opportunity comes up, you've got to take the shot. And then when you add to that the fact that the ice is bad here at the end of a period, another good reason to shoot and not pass.
From the faceoff, Canuck center. And the puck deflects to Tiikkanen, on with Hull and Creighton. Tiikkanen over the red line, into the Vancouver end, gives the puck to Creighton. He'll slide it to the net, kicked out by Hennekin. Boy, you get the idea, the puck just doesn't want to slide at all. Here's Bure working in to Linden. Not a lot in the shot, and that goes wide in the near corner. It's Bure out to Watt, the shot, and it deflects wide. Duchesne with a puck, clearing it up past Tiikkanen, and Lume at center ice. He'll backhand the puck in. Knocked down by Steve Duchesne. Advancing on the far wing to Ellick. He's to the red line, ahead to Roberts. He'll fire the puck in. McLean slows it up behind the net. Carlo centers! Paul, a great save by McLean. Lidstrom a blast! Oh, a pad save by McLean! And the Canucks clear to center ice. Lidster trying to control the puck, gets it, and shoots it in. Two super saves by McLean. Dave Babich for Vancouver around Ellick. Ahead to Ronning in the center circle, not a Momesso. He'll flip the puck in. Left for Holder, around the far side to Ellick. Not a Lidster, in trouble in the corner. Lidster knocked down. The puck behind the Blues net. Here's Bill Holder. Up the right wing to Dave Roberts. Across the ice to Ellick. Over the line. He'll shoot right on. Kirk McLean the save. 4:32 to go. The Blues center. They're changing. No one there. Hoksuda out to Momesso at the red line. And he'll dump it in as Vancouver wants to change players. The Blues and Canucks tied at 5. Long pass for Chassé, trying to work in on the right wing. He's hauled down by Merzen. And the Canucks control in their own end. A pass up for Jeff Courtnall. His pass off for Rannick. Then Barron ahead to Gilbert. Back the other way over the line. Gilbert into the corner. Gilbert checked by Baranek. Now LaPerriere there. Gets the puck. Tries to come in front. Unable to. Baranek slides the puck up the boards. Barron knocks it down. LaPerriere behind the net for Gilbert. He gets crunched to the ice. On a bruising check by Merzen, who clears the center ice. And the puck shot back in by McInnes. Meanwhile, I believe it's LaPerriere. No, Chassé on the ice. Being held by Merzen. And play is stopped. The crowd very unhappy. No call by Terry Gregson. Blues 5, Canucks 5, 3:46 to go in the third period. This is St. Louis Blues hockey.
Kirk McLean comes up with two great chances in goal for Vancouver. The last chance by Doug Lidster. He'll let the long shot go, and the pad save by McLean keeps this game tied at 5.
3:46 to go. McLean probably wondering when the game will end. It has not been a good night. He's had a tough night. Curtis Joseph getting yanked in this third period. It's 5-5, 3:46 to go. LaPerriere, Chassé, and Hull. Hull taking the place on his off wing of Shanahan, who's left with an ankle injury. Linden can't get out of his end on a pass from Babich, and the puck knocked away by Ogic. Here is Norton. Up to Chassé, he'll slide the puck in. LaPerriere after it, looking for Hull in front of pass to Hull. Ogic interferes with Hull. No call. And the puck in the Vancouver end along the far boards. And play stopped. That's not interference. Terry Gregson looks the other way. Brett Hull looking. What was that? Look at him. Brett Hull wondering, and why not?
Well, Hull was breaking down the left side. And Ogic coming back on the play ends up on the back of Hull behind the net. We couldn't see from that replay exactly Ogic and Hull coming together, but it was Hull breaking to the net. Ogic was back. There's no question he got the stick initially, and I'm not sure if he didn't bear hug him before the puck got to him and prevented Hull from getting a shot. The pass across. Hull didn't have a chance to get his stick on it.
Now the faceoff inside the Vancouver blue line. Barron at the left point. McInnes at the right point. 3:23 to go. They drop the puck to Barron. A shot! Oh, what a save! What a drive by Barron. Great save, McLean. Now Linden into the Blues end. He's stood up by McInnes. Barron has the puck in the corner. He's got some time. Stops behind his net. Into the near corner to McInnes. 3 minutes remaining. You can feel the tension. Left wing to LaPerriere, working in on Bure to Chassé in front for Hall. And Hall went one way, the puck the other. Canucks dump the puck out at center ice. It's Al McInnes. Far side to Hull. He blasts it in right on goal. McLean the save. And the play is offside. 2:47 to go in the third period here at Kiel Center. Wow, don't forget, game six, no matter what happens here, will be Wednesday night in Vancouver, and we'll be with you on St. Louis 11 KPLR-TV at 9:30 Central Daylight Time.
And if there's anyone that's carrying the play right now, it's been the Blues. Kirk McLean has had to come up with three or four good saves in the last 3 minutes.
Blues with 34 shots on goal in this game. The Canucks with 25. Vancouver going back in their own end for the puck. Boy, Tiikanen trying to work in. Can't get around the check of Oksuda. A shot and it deflects wide. Tiikanen without a stick, wrestling with Merzen. He gets slugged by Merzen. The puck right in front of the Canucks net. And play stop. Terry Gregson stops play. Wow, what a contest this is. It's not been pretty, but it has been tense and very physical.
And I think it was the linesman that ended up blowing the whistle, Kenny. One of the linesmen from the far side put up his hand. I'm not sure if the puck came off the or outside the zone or not. Meanwhile, the shot by David Roberts deflects off Tiikanen in front and just wide the net. Then Tiikanen and Merzen get tied up. Merzen ends up with the punch to the head of Tiikanen. No call on the play and a welt underneath his left eye.
Boy, Tiikanen is something. The tougher the going gets, the meaner he gets. Oksuda. Momesso. Pass knocked away by Tiikanen. Here's Duchesne. Far side to Norton. Out to center ice. Nice play to Roberts. In over the line to Creighton. He can't get a shot. He's checked. Roberts behind the net. Center and Tiikanen. He shoots. Great save, McLean. Creighton a shot and McLean another save on his side. What a couple of opportunities there for the Blues with 2 minutes remaining in the third, and McLean has been great late in the period.
Tremendous work by Dave Roberts, first setting up Creighton for the shot that was wide, then Roberts from behind, and Tiikanen's in front, has two whacks at it. McLean makes one save, and then Creighton is there as well, and he has a lot of room on the side of the net, and the puck ends up going to the far side. He'll just lay down his arm right across the goal line, and just as he does, the puck will come in, and he's able to make the second save on Adam Creighton. Boy, McLean with a couple of good saves on Tiikanen, and then Creighton with the follow-up, and again, the save.
Blues are out shooting the Canucks 14-8 here in the period. Roberts and Beranek. Beranek wins the faceoff. Babich. Near side to Jeff Courtnall with Beranek and brother Russ. Pass to Russ, tipped in by Russ Courtnall. Barron back behind the net, wrestling with Russ Courtnall. Blues get the puck. Nice play, Roberts, but Hull can't get it out on the first try nor the second. And here's McInnes over the red line. He'll flip the puck in. It goes off Babich to Hull, trying to move in front. And Hedekin back to take the puck. He'll clear it to center ice to Russ Courtnall. Near side to Jeff Courtnall. Beranek to the net. Jeff Courtnall, a pass shot knocked away by Casey. 1:24 to go. Blues can't get out. Jeff Courtnall, a shot. It's blocked by Norton. Beranek checked by Tiikanen and forced to come to center ice after his helmet is wrestled off. And the teams are changing as the Canucks shoot the puck in. There's 1:08 to go. McInnes to Hull at the red line. He'll dump the puck to the Canucks defense. Merzen ahead to Linden, breaking in, trying to get around Norton. He can't. Out near the blue line, a pass broken up by Gilbert. Now to Norton. Here come the Blues. Norton at the red line. 54 seconds to go. A feed in front. LaPerriere dumped by Linden. There'll be a penalty. There'll be a penalty call here by Terry Gregson on Trevor Linden with 48.6 seconds to go. The
Blues, tied at five, will have a power play.
And the Vancouver bench was going crazy. Norton led the rush. He just throws it in. And the Blues are trying to get the shot. That's LaPerriere. And I thought he was actually knocked down by the Vancouver player coming the other way. Now Linden is there, does have a stick around his waist and pulls him down. You can see from the second replay, he had him right around the waist and pulls him down before he can get the shot off. And Linden goes off. 5-5 game, 48.6 seconds to go in regulation time and a power play for the Blues.
Linden hooking, 19-11. Man, oh man, Linden will go to the dressing room. This game is on the verge of going to overtime. We have not seen an overtime game in this best of seven Western Conference quarterfinal series. We've seen just about everything else, however. Tonight, we have seen poor goaltending on both sides. The last 5 to 10 minutes of the period, though, we have seen fabulous goaltending from Kirk McLean. Mike Keenan had to pull Curtis Joseph earlier in this period. That's what a bad night it was for the Blues star goaltender. And maybe the key still, the two shorthanded goals by the Vancouver Canucks in a span of 17 seconds in the second period.
And the Blues are going to have to watch that again. Again, with this ice in this condition, they've got to shoot the puck. If that puck should jump over a stick because of a pass, you've got some guys that look to go on the offense on Vancouver.
Are they making noise here? Wow! Face off to McLean's right. LaPerriere and Ruutu. Ruutu wins the draw. Lume clears it up the boards. Not out. McInnes sends it to the net. Wide. Far point Duchesne. 40 seconds left. Power play Blues. Behind the net to LaPerriere. He's double teamed. Lume gets the puck. But LaPerriere fights back for it. It's poked to the corner by Hull. Here's LaPerriere. He's got Tiikkanen. Tiikkanen shoots. Oh, what a save by McLean. Canucks can't clear. McInnes takes a shot. Oh, deflection by Hull. McLean the save again. Lume clears the puck up ice. Hull makes a nice check. Then Lume wrestles with Tiikkanen. Sends the puck to Merzen behind the net. 10 seconds to go. McInnes pinches in. McInnes loses the puck, and the Canucks clear it out at center ice. 2 seconds to go. We're going to overtime. Game five. This pivotal game goes to overtime. And then as the period ends, Jeff Courtnall jumps on the ice and goes after Esa Tiikkanen. And the linesmen have to restrain them. We're going to sudden death overtime in pivotal game five. And the Canucks and Blues are tied at five.
I think the reason the Vancouver players got so incensed, Ken, was that Tiikkanen looked like on the last pass he deflected it right up over the boards and into the Vancouver bench.
Overtime is next. 5-5, and this is St. Louis Blues hockey. Back to Kiel, just about set for sudden death overtime. Period four, Canucks five and the Blues five. Out of town scores, Detroit beats Dallas 3-1, eliminating the Stars 4-1. In the third at Chicago, the Hawks lead the Leafs 4-2, series tied 2 wins apiece. And in Calgary in the second period, the Flames lead the San Jose Sharks 3-0, that series tied 2 wins apiece. This series, each team has a win at home and a win on the road. 2-2 in games. This is game five. The Blues have a power play for a minute 11 underway. Bure gets the puck, works in on Norton. Backhand shot and a stick save by Casey. Here's McInnes up to Hull. Hull gets to the red line. Left wing for Ellick. Ellick trying to work in into the corner. Bumped by Lumen. Still has the puck. Kicks it behind the net. Now Tiikkanen to Ellick. Tiikkanen knocked down from behind by Merzen. Then the puck taken by the Canucks and fired the length of the ice. 42 seconds remaining in the St. Louis power play. Norton to Hull. To Tiikkanen. He winds up. Left wing. And a shot off Lume over the net. McInnes moves in. Tries to center. Does. But no one there for the Blues. After the puck, Tiikkanen. Tiikkanen, good job on the near boards. In the corner to Hull. Hull spun around by Lume. Lume gets the puck. Flips it to the corner. Roberts there. Then McInnes in.
checked by Merzen. Roberts can't control the puck. He's tripped. And Russ Courtnall fires at the length of the ice. We're a minute into overtime. 10 seconds to go in this Blues power play. Up to Hall, not a Roberts. He'll fire the puck in as he gets hit by Jeff Courtnall. It comes behind the net. McLean up the far wing to Ruutu. Back on the ice, Trevor Linden. Ruutu to the blue line. Long shot wide. Here's Babich pinching in. Babich poke checked into the corner. Hoksuda right point. Linden a shot. Saved by Casey, and he smothers the rebound. What a play by Casey and a long shot by Trevor Linden.
And that might have been deflected in front of the net. Steve Duchesne, one of the Blues defensemen, was in front. The long shot from Linden might have changed directions as Jeff Courtnall was there also, and Casey made a fine save.
Ruutu out of the corner made the pass. Whoa, scary.
Every shot is scary at this point in overtime.
The team that wins this game really gets the big advantage. Of course, the Blues coming into this game with two of the three at home, a best of three series. If you lose this one, woo, you've got to win two in a row early in overtime. Canucks win the draw. Back to Babich. He gets hit. Norton goes down. The puck at center ice. Hoksuda to Babich. He'll backhand it in. It trickles to the side of the net. Duchesne on with Norton. Anderson, Carbonneau, and Gilbert. Here's Duchesne ahead to Norton out of his own end. Pass ahead out of the reach of Carbonneau. Babich gets it to Hoksuda. Two on one to Ronning in front. He fakes. He shoots. He scores! Cliff Ronning in overtime, and the Canucks win pivotal game number five. A two on one break. Ronning scores, and early in the overtime, Vancouver wins it. 6-5 is the final. The Canucks have won twice here in St. Louis. They lead the best of seven series, 3-2.
Well, the Blues had control in their own zone. They give it up in the neutral zone. Duchesne starts it. Norton then loses it, and quickly Babich just off the boards. Norton keeps going. That allows the Canucks to come back 2-on-1. The perfect pass from Hoksuda. And Ronning, knowing Casey's going to come out and be aggressive, with the perfect move. Hoksuda the pass, Ronning waits, Casey commits, Ronning puts it in, and Vancouver leads the series 3-2.
And if you were at home tonight and you want to know more about it, you can read about the Canucks overtime victory tomorrow in the Post-Dispatch. Call 340-8888 and get the Post delivered to your home. Cliff Ronning at 1:48 of overtime with his second goal of the game and his second playoff goal gives Vancouver a victory over the Blues 6-5. Game 6 Wednesday night in Vancouver. We'll return to Kiel Center in a moment. This is St. Louis Blues Hockey. 1 minute and 48 seconds into overtime. Cliff Ronning scores and the Canucks have a 6-5 win. Blues fans, remember, it's not whether you win or lose, it's how you enjoy the game. So always reach for smooth Busch beer and easy drinking Busch Light. Game 5, it goes to Vancouver. They go home with the chance to end the series on Wednesday night. It was a game, as we commented throughout, Joe, that featured poor goaltending. I still think the key may well have been those two shorthanded goals in 17 seconds in the second period by Vancouver.
Yeah, I don't think there's any question about that. They took a 3-1 lead on those two goals. The Blues fought back, though. They did never give up. They found themselves behind many times in this game tonight and kept coming back. And then it was Kirk McLean. We talked about the goaltending, but Kirk McLean was terrific the last half of the third period to hold Vancouver in it before Ronning scores the winner.
So the Canucks now very much in the driver's seat in this best of seven series. We turn now to the three stars of tonight's hockey game, our Busch three stars.
Number three in the night goes to Cliff Ronning, who had two goals for the Vancouver Canucks, including the game winner. The number two star, Brett Hall, also with a couple of goals for the Blues in this game. And the number one star, he had plenty of ice time. He controlled the play. Another strong outing for Jyrki Luumäki, the number one star.
So the situation is the Blues chartered him out of Vancouver, and
It's not a pretty scene when you lose Game 5. And if you look back in history, when the Blues have lost Game 5 in a series, when it was 2-2, they've rarely ever been able to come back.
No, only twice, in fact, in the history of the club. But remember, we've seen a Blues team that has played very well on the road all season long. We're going to see now what the experience on this team has done. It was one of those games where a lot of crazy things happened tonight, different than certainly what we expected. But don't count them out. They've won big games in the past, and they've got a chance to win it again in Vancouver on Wednesday night.
And another situation as we go to Bruce Affleck, the injury, the ankle injury in the third period to Brendan Shanahan. He may well not be able to play. Well, Bruce, what do you think now?
Put the question to me like that now. Well, I think the lights just went out is what I think, Ken, is what happened. Things have not gone well here as the Blues trailed all night long and trying to fight back. But, Kenny, you know, a situation where the Blues have not won two in a row in this series yet, and they're going to have to now to stay alive in the National Hockey League. So that's the bottom line. We go to our play of the game, our Bush play of the game. And obviously it's no question which goal it is. The Blues find themselves caught on a two-on-one situation. It's Cliff Ronning's goal in overtime at 1:48. And Cliff Ronning will come down with Oksuda. You know, and Ronning makes a great move to get around Casey to get the goal, and obviously that's the end of the game, and that's our Bush play of the game.
All right, Bruce Affleck, we hope that the lights going out is not symbolic of anything yet. So the Bush play of the game, Cliff Ronning's goal, Oksuda and Babich assist at 1:48 of overtime. And now it is on to game number 6, Wednesday night in Vancouver. And we hope you'll join us for that. Our thanks to Tom McLaughlin, our producer-director, for Bruce Affleck and Joe Micheletti. This is Ken Wilson. Thanks for joining us at Kiel tonight. Again, the final score in overtime, the Vancouver Canucks 6 and the St. Louis Blues 5. St. Louis Blues hockey has been a presentation of Bud Sports through the facilities of KPLR-TV and KMOX Radio. Our next telecast here on KPLR-TV, St. Louis 11, will be Wednesday night, Game 6 of this quarterfinal, best-of-seven series, the Blues and the Canucks, from the Pacific Coliseum in Vancouver. That telecast will start at 9:30 Wednesday evening, Central Daylight Time.
Playoff hockey has been brought to you by Smooth Bush Beer and easy drinking Bush Light. Your Missouri, Illinois, Lincoln Mercury dealers. McDonald's, proud sponsors of the Blues. Have you had your break today? Southwest Airlines. Fly Southwest, the low fare airline. Pepsi. Nothing else is a Pepsi. The Discover Card. It pays to discover. Your Midwest GMC truck dealers, Bellman, Bomarito, and Brockland GMC. Boatman's, with home equity loans designed to do just one sensible thing, save you money. Your neighborhood St. Louis Chrysler Plymouth dealers. CMS Home Mortgage Corporation. When the bank says no, CMS says yes. Hardee's, starring the best fried chicken in the game today. And by AutoZone, the best parts in auto parts.